Sox by 7. Big move up the lane. Fincher for 3. Front of the rim, got the lip and fell in.
Kings in the lead.
Good play, Mays off the steal. Mays against Gabriel. Yes, it goes. He's fouled and countered.
Here's Williams trying to get him back in. He can't. Gregory, a sophomore, puts it up and in. Gregory had a big game at Chambersburg, 15 points on Saturday night. And here's a steal, and here's Sean Williams puts it in. And the Millionaires are rallying now.
Corey pulls up. McLean, 3 from 3. Yes! He's on fire. He's got 7 threes in the ballgame. Lewisburg needs a timeout. And Sock has built a 16-point lead. And tonight for the Lancer Gym, it's a red-hot Loyal Sock team coming after their 17th win against Hughesville. Having a great year this year at 10-6. A scrappy Hughesville team that Loyal Sock defeated, but in a tough way, back in December. Hi again, everybody. Gary Christman and Babe Mayer, Fairfield Auto Group, Cable Sports Game of the Week, right here from the Lancer Gym. Babe, it is a 16-1 Loyal Sox team, hot off wins over Southern Columbia Bloomsburg, an impressive 10-point win at the Magic Dome last Monday night against the Williamsport Millionaires. Hughesville, meanwhile, has beaten some pretty good teams, including Central, the only team that handed Loyal Sox their only loss of the year. This is a ball club coming in 10-6, playing good basketball, scrappy inside, and a team that gave Loyal Sox all they could handle back in December 21st.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Loyal Sox team, you're right, Gary, is a good ball club. They've got it all. They've got a good point guard in Datris. They've got a shooter in McLean. They've got a great defensive player in Dincher, shot blocker, rebounder, and shooter in Goodell underneath. They've got the whole package plus depth. But on the other side of the coin, you got a Hughesville team that doesn't have the talent, but plays with big heart. Nick Tagliaferri has them playing big ball. They played a good game against Loyal Sox down there. They have some confidence. It's going to be a good ball game.
Yeah, absolutely. We could see Kevin Dincher in this basketball game tonight. Good chance that Kevin will play, will not start. But as far as Hughesville goes, Dan Egley leads the scores at 6'3" inside. You've got Treese Shaner and company. Good balance and double figures for a Hughesville team that'll be playoff bound coming up here in March. We're going to take a timeout. We'll be back. Should be a good ball game. Spartans, the green and white against the maroon and white, the Loyal Sox Lancers. We'll be back. This is the Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week.
We guarantee it. Chevrolets and Cadillacs cost less at Fairfield.
We have the lowest prices, even free delivery.
So you can be sure you'll get a Fairfield fair deal.
Save on every Chevy on our lot, from Cavaliers to Trailblazers to Corvettes.
In stock and ready to go.
How about a Cadillac Escalade or SRX?
We have the lowest prices around.
Even on hard-to-find pre-owned vehicles.
We've got you covered at Fairfield Chevrolet Cadillac.
No games, no surprises, just low, low prices on Chevrolets and Cadillacs.
With a fair deal at Fairfield in Lewisburg. Guaranteed.
I'm Jared Fogle, and I approve this commercial. Trying to eat right, it's tough, especially when McDonald's is spending big bucks to try to get you to eat things like this. Now, I might be just one guy, but here's the truth. A Big Mac has 33 grams of fat. 33 grams of fat. Meanwhile, Subway restaurants have lots of choices, like this tasty, hot, 6-inch cheesesteak sub on fresh baked bread with 10 grams of fat. 10. I made my choice. Make yours. Subway. Choose well.
And once again, we're here at Strong Pool Outlet at the Golden Strip. Gary Christman with Wade Spicer. We're talking pools, talking spas at the lowest prices because they're factory direct to you. Wade, first of all, congratulations on the new store. It's been busy here on the Golden Strip. And the great thing about it, just down the road in Danville, your factory, you build everything and you pass all that savings along to the customer.
That's correct, Gary. This is our newest Strong Pool Outlet location, located on the Golden Strip in Williamsport. Our factory is located in Danville, where we also have a factory store. We build all our products there, above ground swimming pools, spas, pond systems, entry systems for pools. All of it is done right there in Danville.
Okay, great thing right now, whether it's early fall or late fall, either for remaining swimming this year or next season, you've got great deals on above ground pools.
We do. We always have great deals, but now's the time to buy a pool. The deals are more than great now. This is definitely the time to buy an above-ground pool if you're looking for one.
All the chemicals, the accessories, they have those at the store. Now, when you talk about spas, boy, that is the way to go. Out on the deck on a cold night in a spa, you can't beat it, and you build them.
We do, Gary. You can buy pool spa combos. You can buy spas by themselves. We have many, many different models to choose from. If you're even thinking about a spa, at least come down and take a look at ours.
And, of course, in-ground pools, you're a Fox dealer, so even if it's an in-ground pool, Strong Pool can get it done for you.
Our salespeople will be happy to make an appointment, come out to your house, sit down, go through the benefits of an in-ground pool, and get you a price.
Wade, what is that phone number they want to call Strong Pool Outlet? What's the number?
1-800-STRONG-9. 1-800-STRONG-9.
Yeah, easy to remember. 1-800-STRONG-9, Strong Pool Outlet in the Golden Strip, your headquarters for pools and spas at factory direct prices.
Wait till you hear what we see. At Teleflex Communication Systems, we see a whole new generation of digital phones. Smaller, more powerful, smarter, and easier to use than ever. With sound so clear, our customers can hardly believe their ears. If you're looking for something to help you manage your business and your life a little more smoothly, what do you see the integrated phone and voicemail systems we just got from Samsung? Better yet, what do you hear them? Teleflex Communication Systems, locally owned and operated since 1986. Wait till you hear what we see. The Rennie Road Armel Agency has been providing a wide range of insurance products to your friends and family for the past 26 years. Whether you need auto, home, life insurance, business insurance, annuities, CDs, or long-term care insurance, the Rennie Road Armel Agency wants to be your agent for life. We're conveniently located on Westminster Drive and the Penn Hills Plaza. Our friendly, helpful staff is available for all your insurance needs. Call Rennie Road Armel Senior Insurance Agency today.
One of the best moves you can make this year is to have a highlight video of your child's season. Rizzo Productions can produce a professional highlight video of any season, any sport, past or present, with music, titles, and special effects. You can use the video as a recruitment tool for colleges or give it as a gift. Check the website, RizzoProduction.com.
It's your boy Main Event, Wally Dixon, from AM1 ESPN Streetball. Every high school cat need a video. Check out Rizzo Productions, PA Sports Highlight DVD.
And once again, we're back. Teleflex Communications pregame show, part of the Fairfield Autogroup Game of the Week. Gary Christman and Babe Mayer. Sock coming in this ball game, 16-1, rolling along. One thing I've got to say, the Loyal Sock Lancers being undersold in the state top 10. This is a Lancer basketball team that I don't think people realize in the Patriot poll that beat a team, Friars Charter, out of the Philadelphia area, their first game of the year, 67-64. That club is 15-3. They have them ranked something like seventh in the state of Pennsylvania. Loyal Sock, meanwhile, coasting at 16-1. They've been there ranked many times before. Not that this is on CI's mind. He would rather sneak up on people and find out and peak at the right time to go for a fifth straight district title. But this Loyal Sock team, our buddy Dick Mason, our stat man, pointed that out, made a great point. He said, did Lancers beat that team? And look where they're ranked, and Loyal Sock's not there. Sock, though, you know they're going to be there as we get ready for the districts. Tonight, though, they've got to worry about a good Hughesville team, Babe. Let's talk about our Teleflex Communications fast facts about tonight's game.
Well, you talk about a Hughesville team that's on a run, Gary. They've won their last four games. They've scored over 60 points in those last four games, held their opponents to under 40 points in the last four ball games. That's a 20-point differential between the two. They're really playing well right now. There's a lot of football players in this team, and this team came out at the beginning of the season playing more like football players than basketball players. They got their basketball legs now. They're playing well.
Okay, Hughesville, again, last time they played, December 21st, Hughesville in the ball game right into that fourth period, and Loyal Sock won it then, going away 73-59, but it was not an easy game. As Hughesville's got some athletes, that is the key, and you saw how good they played in football this past year on the Cable Sports Game of the Week. So there they go. Anytime you have athletes and guys that can play, anything can happen. And of course, these are guys that can put the ball in the hole with some outstanding balance for this Hughesville Spartan team. Let's talk Subway highlights. Let's take you back to last Monday night when a Lancer team went to the Magic Dome and dismantled the Millionaires.
Mike,
that's
Austin,
the third turnover by the Millionaires.
Look at that battle on the left of your screen with Austin and Goodell had for a few moments as they were in. Now McLean finds Goodell outside. Here's Dencher for Trey. Hits it. Williams tries to get it out there. McLean makes the steal. He's got a 2-on-1. Nice protection, and McLean puts it up and in. Doctors did a great job shielding away the defender. Now a steal. Here's Doctors coming back the other way.
And the Millionaires not setting up well at all.
Here's outside Hefner off the front of the rim. Rebound, Williams has it taken away by Kelly, up and in. Willie Kelly puts it through. There'll be a timeout call. Inbounds by the Millionaires. They're looking for some offense. Parr in the paint, goes up, knocked away by Goodell, and Kelly has it. Here's Dotrus. He'll center. Looks ahead, finds the trailer. Kelly spots it up to the left side, hits it. Kelly for a tray. And the Lancers are just ripping it up.
And that play right there says it all about the Loyal Sock Lancers. The transition, the block in one end, Kelly comes down, hits the three, and Dontra sets it up running the break off the outlet from Goodell. And Loyal Sock playing great basketball in a big place. Williamsport Millionaires may not be having their year, but it is Williamsport. They are Quad A, and they play a heck of a schedule. So you know the Loyal Sock Lancers can play with the good teams, to say the least. And certainly a team under that top 10, but just waiting in the wings to break through there in the top 10 in AA in Pennsylvania. Let's talk about the City Bus Big Play of the Week. Let's talk about it.
All right, this is a play here where you're going to see the teamwork that the Loyal Sock Lancers demonstrate out in the floor. Now watch the motion away from the ball. They're going to end up shooting a layup on this play. Now watch the ball movement, and then watch what they end up with. Millionaires, good tight defense, playing very well against them, but this is typical. Backdoor pass, a little backdoor pass behind the defense. He gets it up off the backboard, easy basket. Ran time off the clock. That was a big play in that ball game.
That's typical Loyal Sock basketball. They extended the lead, went on to win it by 10. Millionaires could get no closer than 7 points in that game. Loyal Sock wins it 63-53. That the City Bus Big Play of the Game. Now, we're going to take a look at the big play of this game coming up in our post-game show, so stick around. We've got Babe Maris, who is he, where is he now, and a whole lot more. Our pre-game show continues, brought to you by Teleflex Communications, phone solutions for your business and home. Now's the time to check it out with Teleflex, locally owned since 1986. We'll be back with more of the Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week. Don't go away.
Wait till you hear what we see. At Teleflex Communication Systems, we see a whole new generation of digital phones. Smaller, more powerful, smarter, and easier to use than ever. With sound so clear, our customers can hardly believe their ears. If you're looking for something to help you manage your business and your life a little more smoothly, what do you see the integrated phone and voicemail systems we just got from Samsung? Better yet, what do you hear them? Teleflex Communication Systems, locally owned and operated since 1986. Wait till you hear what we see.
Customers, only the best tasting coffee will do.
Go ahead, make my coffee.
At Dunkin' Donuts, each and every pot is brewed fresh and served fresh at the peak of its flavor. If you're a tough customer, only the taste of this coffee will do. So go ahead, let Dunkin' Donuts make your coffee
exquisite.
Indeed.
And once again, we're back here at J.P. Stone Granite and Marble with the Granite Guy, Joe Lovarno, West Lincoln Avenue, Southside. And Joe, congratulations. What a year you guys have had.
Yeah, it's been pretty crazy, Gary, with all the customers coming in, picking out different stones. We now have quadrupled our selection on exotic stones from all around the world, reaching people 200-mile radius from this place.
This is spectacular. You talk about the colors and the styles, and, you know, I even picked out mine here. No, I should say you picked it out. Joe picked it out. You know, I just had granite countertops put in my kitchen, and Joe said, here is what will work. This is perfect for your color, and, man, it was great. Great feedback I've had.
Yeah, your kitchen was probably one of the best ones for before and after of a one-day quick redo-over where you didn't have to spend a ton of money.
I'll tell you what, and it's great. Joe Lovarno, now you go computerized to make the work that much more efficient. Let's talk about it.
We spent close to $900,000 on machinery to make everything computerized, basically to get jobs out quicker, but primarily to ensure the customers that it's the best possible job done once it walks out of here. No man can match that kind of quality, not even myself.
I'll tell you what, let's go in and take it out and find out how this works out. All right, Joe, step number one is that much more state-of-the-art this year. Let's talk about some of the new equipment you have.
Well, Gary, what you're seeing here is an electronic templater that actually digitizes people's countertops so that it automatically turns it into a DXL file, and what that is basically what a computer can read. From here, all this information will get sent to the big machine out in the shop that we can go and check it out, and I can explain a little bit more out there.
All right, Joe, we're out here in the shop. What is step number two? What do we do next?
Step number two, Gary, is we'll actually bring the slab in that the customer chose, and the saw behind us is going to cut it in its rough form, And from there, it'll go into the CNC machine, which is a totally automated machine. It does everything that we templated it with that laser in the showroom there. And then from the CNC machine, it will then go to the guys that will touch it up, make sure everything's right, clean it up, seal it several times before it goes to the customer's house, load it up on the A-frames, packed in a truck, and away they go to your house.
I'll tell you what, we talk about taking your kitchen or bathroom to the next level. You really do with J.P. Stone, Granite Marble Joe. Congratulations on a great year and good luck in the future.
Hey, I appreciate that, Gary. Thank you.
I'll tell you what, customers really satisfied with J.P. Stone. Give them a call today, 323-ROCK, West Lincoln Avenue, South Side, J.P. Stone.
At Corders Flooring America, we're with you. With a sales staff trained in flooring and design, here to help you choose the right floor for the way you live. We're with you. With a huge selection of brand name carpet, ceramic, hardwood, laminate, and vinyl floors. We're with you. With professional installation, and even after your floors are installed, we're here to guarantee satisfaction for the life of the floor. From start to finish, count on Corders Flooring America. With you every step of the way.
Your insurance agent should be a friendly face that you can stop by and talk to. No one knows that better than the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn. Since 1932, the Wilkinson Dunn Company has been proudly serving local families, homeowners, and businesses. Our staff lives, works, and volunteers in your community. As an independent agent and trusted choice representative, we offer all types of insurance from a variety of respected insurers. And our focus is always on you, the customer. When it comes to insurance, come to your local professionals, the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn.
My name is Cliff Reeders. I've been practicing law here in Williamsport for 25 years. Back on September 24, 1999, we received a $16.7 million verdict, not a settlement, but a verdict from a jury in a federal case right here in Williamsport, Pennsylvania. They said it couldn't be done. Unfortunately, we see a lot of people who take serious medical malpractice cases to lawyers in Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, Harrisburg, and other places. And you know what? Frequently, those lawyers refer those cases back to us. We are the law firm that other lawyers call to have their serious personal injury and medical malpractice cases tried and tried to result, tried to verdict when that's necessary. I am president-elect of the Pennsylvania Trial Lawyers Association. I am an immediate past president of Citizens for Consumer Justice, the largest consumer umbrella organization in the state. And I'm a past president of the Federal Bar Association for the Middle District of Pennsylvania. I've written a number of books, including the leading text on medical malpractice in Pennsylvania. If you want quality legal representation in serious cases, in serious medical malpractice, and in serious personal injury cases, I urge you to call us. We don't charge to talk to you, and I do talk to everybody who calls me. The name of the firm is Reeders, Travis, Humphrey, Harris, Waters, and Waffenschmidt. And I'm Cliff Reeders.
Welcome back to the pregame show. Babe Mayer along with the head coach from the Hughesville Spartans, Nick Tagliaferri. Nick, I tell you what, you got the Spartans playing basketball as well as they've played since your tenure started down in Hughesville.
Yeah, you could say that. We still got a long way to go, though. We're trying to, like a lot of teams, I'm sure, we're trying to fight through some injuries and some sickness, and we got them all back tonight, finally, and we're going to see how things go and see if we peak at the right time.
Well, you're 10-6. Two more wins put you in the playoff, and you tell me you get a couple more wins, you have a good chance of getting a high seed.
Yeah, there's a lot of teams in our district that are right around the 500 mark, and we're hoping that we can play well the last eight games of the year and win the games that we should win. We could situate ourselves fairly well. You know, that's even with the three-game losing streak we had in the middle of the year. So, you know, we got to take it one game at a time and just see what happens.
Last four games, played some great ball. Four wins, held the opponents to under 30 points a game. That's something. But you scored over 60 points a game yourself. That's really amazing.
Yeah. Well, to be honest with you, middle of the year, we kind of challenged our kids. We weren't playing defense the way we're capable of playing defense. And that's where it starts for us. If we get stops, we like to get out and transition a little bit, you know, and take advantage of our weapons that we have. We have some weapons on offense, but for us, everything starts on the defensive end. I'm proud of them guys for stepping up. We just got to keep going, keep playing defense.
You know, you had a basketball career at Jersey Shore, of course, then at Lake Cumming College, and yeah. Both those places, it was really offense-oriented. Matter of fact, when you played at Lake Cumming, it was a three-point team, but yet defense is your forte here.
Yeah, definitely. I believe that you can't win unless you defend. Win championships, win a lot of games. in college, you know, as much as we were offensive and high flying and shooting all the threes, we definitely preached defense night and night out, and that was kind of like my role, I guess you could say, in college. So I just kind of took it with me, you know, to coaching.
This is a team that has a lot of football players on it. Oftentimes, football players still have football legs coming out of the season. Is this team over the football legs and into basketball?
Yeah, I think we are. That was the major concern that we had early in the year. I have four guys that play basketball through the fall, and four other ones, three of them were football. And this, I'm talking to my main eight rotation. Three other ones played football and one played soccer. And it took us a good month and a half to get those guys all meshing together. We hope lately that things are starting to click and they're starting to get, you know, into a basketball flow. And, well, you know, we haven't practiced that much lately with the weather, so we'll see how we look tonight, you know.
Okay, Coach, what's the keys to tonight's game? What do the Spartans have to do to win this ball game?
Definitely the most important thing for us is we got to play loose tonight. The last time we played Loyal Sock, we were very tight. I'm not sure why, but we did a lot of things out of character, especially in the defensive end of the floor. And I think if we come out here and play loose like we have been tonight and carefree, we'll play decent defense, I hope, and that'll turn into some things on offense. Obviously, we got to handle their pressure. I think defensive rebounding tonight for us will be big. They're a little bit bigger than we are. We're pretty athletic inside, even though we're only 6'2 in there, but we need to block out, control the glass if we're going to have a chance of winning. If we do that, you know, we should have a good game.
Have a good game tonight, Coach.
Thank you. Thanks for coming out.
We'll be back with more of the pregame show right after these messages.
The Sports Medicine Center of the Divine Providence Hospital campus of Susquehanna Health System is the area's only comprehensive care center for sports injuries. Accessible care is easy with our team of board-certified orthopedic surgeons, certified athletic trainers, and physical therapists. Our dynamic physical therapy department uses a unique hands-on approach. The Sports Medicine Center offers an outreach athletic training service to regional high schools and colleges. The Sports Medicine Center of Susquehanna Health System, the best comprehensive care to get you back in the game.
Four locations. First rate selection. Fair deals. The Fairfield Auto Group.
You know, you talk about phone solutions for your business at home, you've got to be talking about Teleflex Communications. Gary Christman back here with Rex Stalnaker at Teleflex. And I'll tell you, the amazing thing about Teleflex, you've been doing it since 1986. The Ruskowski family still owns it here in the Williamsport area. Local service, local people, friendly people. That's been a key for Teleflex for a lot of years.
Definitely a key. We've been very proud of the fact that we are locally owned and operated right here in Williamsport. And this is really the core of our operation, the Williamsport area, or 50 miles within Williamsport area.
Okay, you talk about business. Certainly a key when you have Samsung and Panasonic. Great phone solutions for a large corporation or a small business with just a few phones. You can cover either one.
We can cover the small business or we can cover the very large business, depending on really what their needs are. And that's the way we designed the phone system. But recently, we've started beginning to get into the home environment or the residential environment. Because a lot of the businessmen who have our systems are now asking for more and more from their phone system at their home for home automation, et cetera. And we have begun to expand into the home environment.
Okay, kids are driving you crazy. You want voicemail, you want paging, you want conferencing, you want everything under the sun. You can do the same thing at home as you do at work, right?
That's right. The Panasonic and the Samsung system have a lot of features and a lot of flexibility to really adapt to the homeowner.
Certainly one of the big advantages, probably the biggest, is local service after the sale, and that's why you guys are there almost instantly.
That's right. We average about a two-hour response time within the Williamsport area, and the service environment is really the cornerstone of the industry that we're involved with today.
Teleflex Communications, phone solutions that work for your home and your business. Check them out today with Samsung and Panasonic. Rex, good luck. Looks like it's another great year.
Terrific year. Thank you, Gary.
We'll see you the next time from Teleflex Communications.
Talented, experienced, and outstanding craftsmen. These are words used to describe the goldsmiths at Blair Brothers. Exquisite gemstones and diamonds, unequal designs and incredible detail. These are words used to describe the jewelry at Blair Brothers Goldsmiths. Each goldsmith is passionate about the quality of their work. You'll realize a fresh new attitude paid to you and your jewelry. You'll be treated with respect and care, and your custom jewelry will show it. Experience the new artistry and fresh new attitude awaiting you at Blair Brothers Goldsmiths.
No longer can you call Orlando's Main Street Muncie the best-kept secret in Muncie, PA. Hi, everybody. Gary Christman here at Orlando's for great, authentic Italian food and so much more. And certainly an atmosphere that gives you that old-world charm. The whole family is here. And, Mike, when you talk about a great menu and a place that's been here a long time, you guys have been at it a few years.
Since 1962. Been here 43 years.
When you talk about, you know, some of the signature dishes and what you've been known for, what can we find here at Orlando?
Well, we're known best for Dad's homemade raviolis. And we run a fresh catch and pork tenderloin, different steak specials and fish specials every night.
I've had them. You've got to have the ravs when you come here to Orlando's. Lot of years, and every time you turn around, you guys are adding more to this renovation.
Yeah, we've been working at this for a long time, and I think we'll have Matt show you around.
Okay, let's take the tour of Orlando's. Well, it gives you a good look at the old world charm here at Orlando's in Muncie. It looks like you could be in a villa in southern Italy right here. Really looks nice.
Thanks a lot, Gary. That's the look we were going for here at Orly's. Very comfortable place to eat. We have four different dining rooms, whether you just want an intimate dinner with you and your wife, or bring the whole family down.
Cover a pretty good sized group here for a special occasion.
Yes, we can. We can seat up to 50 people. We've just put in a beautiful new banquet room. But let's go back in the kitchen and see where it all happened.
Well, the food smells great. It looks great. Mike, what do we have here tonight?
Well, tonight we're running a pork tenderloin Fiorentino. We have our salmon catch of the evening. Of course, our homemade raviolis. One of our appetizer plates, the Mediterranean plate. And this is our signature dish, Gary. You got to try this out. This is a Greco-Roman penne.
Wow, that looks great. Okay. This looks tough to beat. Outstanding. Well, that was the tour for a traditional old world theme in a hometown setting. The place to go for the finest food around, Orlando's, Main Street, Muncie. Sports Medicine Center, Coach's Corner. We're back, part of the Fairfield Game of the Week. Gary Christman and CI Ron Ensinger going after the 17th win. Lancers, big win. I missed you last. Of course, I had to go to Cancun. It was tough.
I don't feel sorry for you, Gary.
I know you won, but I did call back to see what that score was. Lancers win by 10, a couple of other big games last week. And now a Loyal Sox team playing a Hughesville team that played you pretty tough the first time back in December.
They certainly did. They just have a great, well-rounded team. They've got a good inside game. They got an excellent perimeter game and a great coach that, you know, has really motivated the kids. And they're playing hardball for 32 minutes.
Right now, where do you put your team? You've had great teams over the years. You've had teams that were Cinderella teams early that nobody said could win the districts. You win it. You win it. Then you were the favorite team to win it. Going after five in a row. Where are you right now with the playoffs looming just around the corner?
Well, Gary, we've still got to pick it up a couple notches. You know, exactly where we are as far as a level of play, I think we're pretty much on exactly where we want to be. However, you know, we've got Kevin Dincher on the bench right now with an injury.
Will he play tonight? What is his
No,
start?
He won't play tonight. It's day by day. He's close. He's very close to getting back. But we want it at full strength. We want to be able to, so he's at the top of his game going into the districts and the state playoffs. So, you know, we're looking at the big picture for Kevin. So we've kind of been very conservative to, you know, getting him back into playing time. But as far as the other guys, I think, you know, we went to a mini slump there in midseason, and we've gotten out of that. We've gotten that behind us, and I think we're starting to reach the peak.
How much did that millionaire win mean to you the other night? You've beaten better millionaire teams in the past with the Loyal Sox teams in the 90s, but still, you beat Williamsport up there, always big for your program.
It was a big win for us, very big win. Williamsport pulled out all guns. You know, that was a must-win for them. So that had a playoff atmosphere. And for us to go up there, you know, we're probably a 10, 15-point underdog just because it's in the Magic Dome. So I was really proud of
it. I had you favored, you know. I put the pressure on. I said, first time ever favored, and it did play out.
Yeah, well, the thing is that we had to play hardball also to beat them. They gave us pressure like we probably won't see all the way through. So it was a win-win situation for us.
Okay, tonight, let's talk about to win again and win your 17th. Game plan against a very good Nick Tagliaferri coach Spartan team.
Well, we're going to have to be patient in offense. We're going to have to execute. And Billy, Patrick, Willie are going to have to control the inside. And that's going to be a big challenge for them because they've got some bangers inside. They've got some hustle. They've got a lot of athleticism. And so it's a great test for us. When we had Kevin in the game at Hughesville, in fact, that's the game he got hurt. He fell into the stands. You know, they gave us everything we could take. And so it's going to be a great challenge tonight.
Good test. CI, good luck. Go get another one.
Thanks a lot, Gary.
We'll take a timeout. We'll take a break. We'll be back with more. This is the Susquehanna Health System Sports Medicine Center Coach's Corner. We'll be back with more of the Fairfield Game of the Week from Loyal Sock. Don't go away. Sports-related injuries can happen to the best athletes. Whether you're a varsity athlete, experienced runner, cyclist, play golf, or baseball, a sport-related injury could sideline you. The only comprehensive care center for all types of sports injuries in the area is the Sports Medicine Center, located on Divine Providence Hospital campus of Susquehanna Health System.
Returning all athletes to their highest level of performance is the focus of the Sports Medicine Center. This unique environment where athletes treat athletes will get you back to your peak performance in the fastest and safest amount of time. Accessible care is easy with our team of board-certified orthopedic surgeons, certified athletic trainers, and physical therapists. To complement our special orthopedic care, we offer a dynamic physical therapy department that uses a unique hands-on approach to evaluate and treat patients. Our on-site x-ray and the advantage of having the latest technology, a Susquehanna MRI, decreases the time it takes for determining your injury and planning the best treatment.
The Sports Medicine Center offers an outreach athletic training service to regional high schools and colleges. This program places certified athletic trainers in the field to meet the needs of the athletes. This includes a prevention and early intervention injury care program.
Whether you're physically active at 7 or 70, the Sports Medicine Center of Susquehanna Health System will provide you with the best comprehensive care to get you back in the game.
Wait till you hear what we see. At Teleflex Communication Systems, we see a whole new generation of digital phones. Smaller, more powerful, smarter, and easier to use than ever. With sound so clear, our customers can hardly believe their ears. If you're looking for something to help you manage your business and your life a little more smoothly, what do you see the integrated phone and voicemail systems we just got from Samsung? Better yet, what do you hear them? Teleflex Communication Systems, locally owned and operated since 1986. Wait till you hear what we see.
Welcome to Vanderland Gallery and Custom Framing. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Christman. You know, one of the best ways of preserving your son or daughter's sports career is by framing their memorabilia. Whether it's a varsity letter, a jersey, or medals, it's something they're going to cherish forever. Or maybe there's something you'd like to preserve. I had some of my Sports Illustrated covers framed. Vanderland Gallery features work from many artists working in a variety of mediums. For the framing of sports memorabilia, a piece of fine art, or a print, there's Vanderland Gallery and Custom Framing.
This 1998 Montgomery High School graduate would set school records and District 4 records in football and track. On the high school gridiron, he would set records for most touchdowns scored and total rushing yardage for a season and career. In track, he would win district championships in the 100, 400, and long jump. He would go on to play wide receiver and run track at Slippery Rock University, where he would become an All-American in football and track. His Slippery Rock football team would win three conference championships, aided by his play at wide receiver and his 10 kick returns for touchdowns, both a school and conference record. In his senior season, he would lead the nation in kickoff returns, averaging 39.9 yards a return. He would also lead the Slippery Rock Tracksters to three conference championships, and he would be named to the Division II All-American team. Following college, he was drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers and now plays professional football in Canada. Who's this week's Rennie Rodarmo All-State Insurance? Who is he and where is he now? Well, stay tuned at halftime for the answer, and stay tuned for more of the Teleflex Communications pregame show, where I'm joined by Gary Christman with the Price Optical Athlete of the Week.
Okay, we are set. Price Optical Athlete of the Week, and this week it is Lewis Ruskowski. That's right. Two back-to-back big games for Bishop Newman. 23 against Jersey Shore, 22 against Bucktail. Lewis Ruskowski, the Price Optical Athlete of the Week. There's no doubt, there's a guy that can put it in the hole. A big coming back to Bishop Newman. He was here at Loyal Sock early this year, and he's certainly a great addition.
I'll tell you what, Lewis Roskowski, with the return of Whaley back in the lineup, has taken some of the pressure off of him. He stepped up his offensive game, had two great offensive games, leading Bishop Newman into a playoff situation where they should be seated fairly high in District 4.
Hats off, Lewis Roskowski, Bishop Newman, Golden Knights, back-to-back big games, and put up the numbers back-to-back against Jersey Shore and Bucktail. A big week for Lewis Roskowski. Again, Price Optical Athlete of the Week. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with more. This is the Teleflex Communications pregame show, locally owned since 1986. Phone solutions for your business or home from Samsung and Panasonic. We'll be back with a Fairfield Game of the Week. Don't go away.
At Price Optical, we set our sights on your vision. Our focus is on providing complete quality eye care. Our selection includes designer frames by Giorgio Armani, Tommy Hilfiger, Ralph Lauren, and Calvin Klein. If specialty frames is what you're looking for, check out the durable, rimless frames by Silhouette and Kawasaki. We also have kids' frames. At Price Optical, our selection is great and our service is better. After all, quality is always the best deal. Price Optical, for the finest in eyewear.
The Rennie Road Armel Agency has been providing a wide range of insurance products to your friends and family for the past 26 years. Whether you need auto, home, life insurance, business insurance, annuities, CDs, or long-term care insurance, the Rennie Road Armel Agency wants to be your agent for life. We're conveniently located on Westminster Drive and the Penn Hills Plaza. Our friendly, helpful staff is available for all your insurance needs. Call Rennie Road Armel Senior Insurance Agency today.
Now we go to Phil live at the big game.
Well, I don't know what it's like outdoors, but I've got 72 degrees and a really great seat.
Yeah, who cares if it snows when you're
under the dome, huh?
Dome schmoam, pal. I'm at home. Go, go, touchdown, yes!
Well, here's who to call for custom-made indoor weather in your dome. Schmoam, home.
Call Forsberg Furnace Company, your Carrier dealer, at 322-3392.
Carrier, custom-made indoor weather.
You know, when you talk about great trips anywhere in the world, you've got to join AAA Travel. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Crispin here at Kailua Beach in Oahu. We're experiencing a great luau here. You can hear that in the background. Join AAA Travel no matter where it will be. Here in Hawaii, maybe Bermuda, the Caribbean for cruises, all inclusive to the Caribbean, great getaway weekend packages, even Europe. Give them a call today, 323-8431. AAA, the most trusted name in travel. I've got a luau to go to. Aloha. Welcome to the world of Blair Brothers Goldsmiths here in the Oaks Plaza on the Golden Strip. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Christman with John and Bill Blair. And guys, congratulations on a terrific start.
Thank you, Gary. We really want to thank the public and the community for coming out to support us and making it a great beginning.
I'll say what, I guess you're going to give me the showroom tour, this spectacular showroom. Let's take a look. Boy, John, this really did turn out great. Beautiful showroom.
Yeah, it was absolutely perfect. This is everything we dreamed it would be. But, you know, we really want the public to know that we can suit them with anything, whether it's diamonds, tanzanites, or garnets. We have it all in-house for you to look at. We have different items, pottery, glassware, we have leather goods, you know, we make our own silver. Anything you want, we have it. It's available for different holidays, graduation, weddings, we have it.
And the great thing about it, any customer, no matter what job, large or small, they're spending $28 to $2,800, they get that same respect from you guys.
Absolutely.
Okay, we're here in the back room, the workshop here at Blair Brothers Goldsmiths. And Bill, why don't you give me the tour here, how it all begins at Blair Brothers.
Gary, this is where it happens. It starts back here in our workshop. The design, the creativity, the pieces start here.
And creativity is the name of the game.
Our creativity compared to anybody else's is fabulous.
Okay, and when you talk about detail, you pride yourself in the finest detail anywhere in Central PA in the jewelry business anywhere.
Absolutely. If you don't believe us, come on in. We'll take you into the back. We'll show you the difference between our work and somebody else's.
And you don't mind inviting people back, and as you're building their piece, they can watch you create it as you do it.
That's right, Gary. If you're not happy, we're not happy.
You've got a great staff, too.
Brian Renninger is here working on a custom piece, paying close attention to the exquisite detail. Tim Scholl, he's been doing this for 18 years. Master goldsmith, loves his job. Great guys.
So discover the world of Blair Brothers Goldsmiths, Oaks Plaza on the Golden Strip for those extra special moments. Get a taste of the old world charm at Orlando's Main Street Muncie. No longer the best kept secret in Muncie, PA. Since 1962, they've evolved in one of the finest restaurants in all of central Pennsylvania. It's a great atmosphere for quiet dining for two or bring all the family and friends. Of course, they're known for their authentic Italian cuisine and so much more, like Greco-Roman penne and Dad's homemade ravioli and their signature pork tenderloin. For lunch or dinner, make it Orlando's Main Street Muncie.
Believe in angels? Midas Records proudly presents the debut album from pop sensation Angel, Believe in Angels, Believe in Me, featuring her hit single, Just the Way I Am. Don't miss Angel this fall on the VH1 Save the Music Tour, coming to a city near you. Check out angelfaith.net for the latest news, tour dates, and more. Believe in Angels, Believe in Me, in stores now.
Hi, everybody. I'm Babe Mayer, director of the Mayer Sport Training Center with this week's Teleflex Communications Sports Training Tip of the Week. Speed training in sports is defined as the ability of an athlete to go from point A to point B in the shortest time. This includes moving forward and backward, side to side, and crossover actions over varying distances. Training for sports speed requires training all these multi-directional movements equally. Too often athletes training for speed place too great an emphasis on running straight ahead or running a longer distance than necessary. For example, football linemen need to train for multi-directional quick movements over a short distance. A basketball player needs to move in multiple directions within the length of the court, or a soccer player needs to move multi-directionally within the length of the field. Speed training drills should work within these guidelines. Professional speed coaches know that the most important aspect of training speed is training one's ability to accelerate and decelerate. Training to accelerate and decelerate can be done by training quick multi-dimensional movements on an agility ladder or in a small area, utilizing high repetitions to master movements. The sports training tip of the week is brought to you by Teleflex Communications Phone Solutions that work for your business and your home, and the Mayer Sport Training Center, located in Ragnar's Racquetball and Fitness Center, offering state-of-the-art training for the serious athlete of all ages.
All right, babe, we're set. 21st Century Sign, keys to the ball game tonight. Loyal Sock taking on the Spartans of Hughesville. Nick Taglaferri, last time we saw him, he was playing for the Lycoming College Warriors. Great player, had a great career at Jersey Shore. Good to see local players come back to coach, and certainly Nick Taglaferri has given the Spartans a real edge locally. Very competitive. Now they're 10-6. They're playoff bound. Gave Loyal Sock all they can handle. Let's talk about keys to tonight's ball game.
Well, I think the keys to tonight's ball game for Hughesville is that they've got to get Loyal Sock to play their game. They like to play a rugged game. They like to play a physical game, and they need to get Loyal Sock caught up in it. Loyal Sock, on the other hand, likes to play a finesse game. If they can get into a finesse game and Hughesville tries to match up with them, there's going to be problems. So I think who dictates the tempo of tonight's game is going to make the difference.
And there's no doubt Hughesville has athletes inside. Jordan Kilburn is their leading rebounder coming. It gives you double digits with a dozen points a game. Dan Egley leads with 13.6 rebounds. And, of course, you know, some outstanding players. John Treese gives you 10 points a ball game. You've got Mike Lacher. You've got Shaner. These are all good athletes. You remember seeing Lacher in football this past year. So certainly Hughesville coming in, trying for the upset against Loyal Sock. Remember, the Lancers don't have Kevin Dinger. They had him the last time they played. Should be fun. Should be a good ball game. We'll take a break. We'll be back. This has been the 21st Century Sign Keys to the Ball Game. We'll be back with a Subway Dunkin' Donuts starting lineups right after this timeout. Sock, take it on Hughesville.
I'm Jared Fogle, and I approve this commercial. Trying to eat right, it's tough, especially when McDonald's is spending big bucks to try to get you to eat things like this. Now, I might be just one guy, but here's the truth. A Big Mac has 33 grams of fat.
33 grams of fat?
Meanwhile, Subway restaurants have lots of choices, like this tasty, hot, 6-inch cheesesteak sub on fresh-baked bread with 10 grams of fat. 10. I made my choice. Make yours. Subway. Choose well.
Insurance for your home, for your family, for your life, for your business. The insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn are here for you. Our staff lives, works, and volunteers in your community, and we are proud of the personal, high-quality service we provide. We are a local independent agent, and that allows us to serve you first and find you the most competitive rates. Home, auto, business, life, and health. When it comes to insurance, make the best choice, the trusted choice, the faces you know, the service you deserve. The insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn Company.
Why, the name is Furlinger, Bud Furlinger, veteran city bus driver. Why, it's been a long time since I drove one of these buses. Now I drive this new bus, and riding city bus has never been easier. See what some of my riders have to say.
With a new easy fare system, one fare takes you anywhere.
I love the new Trade and Transit Center and the Williamsport trolleys.
And I ride the Tri-Town Connector to work from Montgomery.
The new Leon buses work great.
Seniors, get your free gift certificates just for riding city bus. Sign up at the Trade and Transit Center, downtown Williamsport.
Plus, my new girlfriend can ride the bus to visit me. Oh!
City bus, we take pride in every ride.
Confidence, strength, compassion, integrity, loyalty, honesty. Words that should be associated with the law firm that represents you. Readers Travis Humphrey Harris Waters and Waffenschmidt are truly the difference. The attorneys and their staff have a proven track record for standing by and supporting their clients through difficult circumstances. Located in historic downtown Williamsport, Pennsylvania, the Readers Travis Law Firm concentrate in accident and personal injury, medical malpractice, motor vehicle and insurance claims, defective products, workers' compensation, civil and employment rights, and criminal cases in both the state and federal courts. Their experience is on your side. Call today at 800-326-9259 or visit them online at www.readerstravis.com.
One of the best moves you can make this year is to have a highlight video of your child's season. Rizzo Productions can produce a professional highlight video of any season, any sport, past or present, with music, titles, and special effects. You can use the video as a recruitment tool for colleges or give it as a gift. Check the website, RizzoProduction.com.
It's your boy Main Event, Wally Dixon, from A1 ESPN Streetball. Every high school cat need a video. Check out Rizzo Productions, PA Sports Highlight DVD.
For Fair Deals, Fairfield Game of the Week. I'm Gary Crispin along with Dick Stein of Fairfield Toyota on the Golden Strip. Dick, first of all, congratulations. A great record-breaking 04 again. Year in and year out, you keep doing that. And, of course, 05 is coming. Now, you had the best-selling car in the United States in Toyota Camry, best-selling car in the world in Toyota Corolla, and now Toyota is what, the best-selling line of cars in the USA?
Best-selling line of automobiles, cars in the United States of America.
What about 05s now? A lot of exciting new things. What are you really talking about most about 05?
05, Gary, is going to be wonderful. We've got new products coming, a new Tacoma truck. It's more powerful, it's larger, it's longer, it hauls more. Choice of beds, long bed, short bed, composite boxes, no more bed liners. Just going to be a great truck.
That's exciting. Now, I also hear big things about the new 05 Toyota Avalon. A lot of style, a lot of luxury. Tell me more.
New Avalon's going to be really great. It's due now. Larger, more luxurious, heated rear seats, all the things people want. It's going to be a wonderful car.
It's going to be exciting. Also, something exciting coming soon to Fairfield Toyota. Sometime in 05, we're not going to let it all out of the bag yet, but I understand there's a new location for Fairfield Toyota, brand new store.
Brand new store, new location, three times the size, lots of room, state of the art. It's going to be wonderful.
It's going to be exciting.
Yes,
well,
it is.
Dick, congratulations. Great job at 04. Break another record this year. Let's do it for 05.
Thank you, Gary.
Dick Stein, Fairfield Toyota on the Golden Strip. Whatever you do, make it Fairfield for fair deals. More with the Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week. Don't go away.
Tax preparers, financial planners, attorneys, florists. Now is the perfect time for you to advertise 41,000 homes in Lycoming County. Your message will reach a targeted audience enjoying the music on Suscom 2, an audience who is involved in the community and looking for things to do. Suscom 2 Classifieds is a simple and cost-effective way to get your message to thousands of local viewers in need of assistance with things like tax preparation, legal matters, financial investments, gift ideas, and more. Call me today to find out how simple and cost-effective it is to advertise on Suscom 2 Classifieds on Channel 2.
Fairfield for fair deals, Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week. Gary Crispin and Babe Mayer watching Thursday at 7 and also Sunday morning at 10 right here on Suscom Channel 2. This Fairfield Game of the Week. And Fairfield reminds you, they've got great deals on 05s and remaining 04s at their Fairfield locations. Four locations, eight lines of cars with Fairfield. All right, we're just about ready for the playing of our national anthem. Hughesville Spartans taking on the Loyal Sock Lancers. Good ball game, and again, a good turn-up for both teams as they get ready for the playoffs. Now our national anthem. Sox 16-1, and the Hughesville Spartans coming in 10-6. They play December 21st. Loyal Sox winning at 73-59. Here's our Subway Dunkin' Donut starting lineups for this basketball game tonight. Hughesville, the guards, Shaner and Lacher. John Treese will give you 10 points a game. Inside, you've got Kilborn and Egley. Big guns inside for this basketball team. As their lineup comes out, Shaner comes out.
6'3" junior, Dan Egley.
There's big Dan Egley. 6'3", 13 points a game for Hughesville.
6'2" senior, John Treese.
Here comes John Treese. Good size at guard at 6'2", 10 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists a game.
Mike Lacher.
Here's Mike Lacher, the great all-around athlete, outstanding football player, was one of our stars of the game in football. 6 foot senior guard, 7 points a game. And then you've got Jordan Kilborn, 12 a game, 6'2" junior forward, gives you 10 rebounds per game and shoots 51% from the floor and gives you some big block shots with 24 in the season coming in. Here's our look at the Loyal Sox Lancers starting lineups for this basketball game.
Loyal Sox Lancers have a starting five, Gary. They go about nine deep, though. They have a lot of depth in this team, and Roddy Ensinger uses that depth well.
Here comes Corey Dockris out there. He runs the show. He's the guy that makes it happen. Billy Goodell is 6'8". He just gets better and better, only a junior.
Number 14, a 6 foot senior, Mike
McClain. The last time we saw him, the last time I saw him, of course, they did the Loyal Sox game with Ken filling in for me and Babe last week. Mike shot out the gym, 30 points, 8 threes, a school record. Nate Discher gives you the great D. He'll pick up their best player offensively. And very solid Pat Carey playing for the injured Kevin Discher. They're bringing along slowly because the bottom line is they want to get set and ready as they get ready for the season and the playoffs coming up. I believe a cheerleader just had a little bit of an incident and hit the deck, and hopefully they'll get her squared away. I don't know if anybody had a chance to see it. Barb Anderson attending to her, and hope she's going to be all right.
But I think she's fine. She's more embarrassed than she is hurt. Barb's going to take her out of the gym, and she'll be all right.
How do you know she's more embarrassed than she is hurt?
Well, because she walked off the gym with no problem. she had her hand in her hand over her eyes. So
I hope she's all right.
I think she is, but that's one of the things they built those pyramids.
I get more embarrassed sometimes up here than I am hurt.
Back in your days, you used to build those pyramids about 8 high, see, and a couple people fall and get hurt. Now they got a limit how high they can go.
All right, Sock controls it. Goodell got it away, and here come the Lancers. They give it to Mike McClain. He can be that scoring machine. Gives you 14.2 per game, but lit it up with 30 and 8 threes. He was on fire against Lewisburg back in the 14th. McClain. Hughesville Spartans giving him D. Goodell coming out to meet him as Kilborn. Gilborn's going to try to put some good D on. He's a good shot blocker down there. Backdoor, good feed. Dencher down to Goodell for two. Billy Goodell sticks it in for a 2-0 lead.
Good body control by Billy Goodell. Got that ball a little bit underneath. Had enough sense to drop back a little bit, put it off the backboard. They got a 2-0 lead.
Jumper, outside shot would not go down, but John Treese. Rebound comes down to the Lancers. Dencher. Dotrus facing the man-to-man. To Dencher again. Nick Tagliaferri's done a great job with this program. Going to try to make this team year in and year out an outstanding competitive playoff-bound team with Hughesville. He's done a really good job. He was a great player at Jersey Shore and like coming.
This team starts off the Hughesville Spartans on defense. They've got to play good defense. They're in a man-to-man right now. Good job of matching up.
Mike McLean, if his shot goes down early, you know he's on fire. Good hustle rebound. Mike Lacher pulled it down. Arrow points Hughesville. They get it back as he pulled it away from Billy Goodell at 6'8".
They're going to have to collapse on Billy Goodell. He's got rebounds on both ends of the board. That time he brought it down and Lacher jumped onto him and tied him up. But if he controls the boards, the Spartans are going to have trouble.
Egley pulls it down, goes off the foot of Treese, and out of bounds. Hughesville turns it over. 2-0 lead right now. Loyal Sock, big wins last week over Southern Columbia and Bloom. First, their only loss coming to Central Columbia. They were stunned by that ball club that Hughesville has beaten Central this year. Here's a feed down low, ganging up in the middle. Good defensive play as they gang up inside. Little double team action as they try to surround Goodell with Kilborn and company, and Egley, and the ball comes out. Lacher runs the point.
Well, what they're doing is they're fronting and backing him. That time they got a good bracket on him. He never got the shot off, but Goodell again controlling the boards in the defensive end.
Turnaround shot, Egley wouldn't go. Dotrus running the point. Lacher on him. You put a good athlete out there trying to shut Corey's game down because he makes it happen. Goodell, the turnaround shot won't go. Carey powers it back up. Pat will put it up, and it will not go in. Out of bounds, Lancers get it back. This ball club from Hughesville played with them to the end before Lancers pulled away 73-59. Ironically, it was a game that Kevin Dencher was injured in with that shoulder injury back on December 21st. Jumper, Dotrus will not go down. Big rebound pulled down, but Kilborn, who gives you 10 rebounds per game. Kilborn, one-on-one against the big guy. Goodell got a piece of it. A 3-on-2. McLean away. Carey gets hammered, blocked, and fouled. And Pat Carey to the line with a two-shot foul. 2-0 Sock. We played nearly 3 minutes.
It was a good block by the man up on top. They got a body shot underneath. Lacher's going to get the foul called on him. His first, team's first. Pat Carey will go to the foul line shooting two.
Pat Carey to the line. Shot goes up and rolls in. 3-0 lead Sock.
Lancers really shoot well from the foul line. Tremendous percentages.
Second shot goes in. 4-0 lead Loyal Sock. They play half court pressure.
Pat Carey shoots 70% from the foul line.
Kilborn has a seam, gets by Goodell and hits. Good play. Jordan Kilborn turns it up and in, got him around the left side to cut it to 4-2.
Good job. Kilborn got Billy Goodell away from the basket, beat him on the first step, got that leverage to the basket, did a good job of putting it away.
Dotrus, good denial. Lacher. Hughesville playing good D early against Sock, trying to hold this team down. Sock can score a bundle of points. Right side, Carey. Carey turns, spins, shoots, and it will not go down. Kilborn the rebound. Lacher. Outlet comes back down the other way. Here's Shaner. Baseline, Egley. Tries to back in, denied by Carey. Treese. Back to Kilborn. Shot won't go. Draws the foul.
Billy
so far playing some good basketball, yeah, in a 4-2 low-scoring game. As long as Hughesville plays this type of game defensively, hanging with the Lancers, anything can happen.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, great matchup underneath Goodell and Kilborn. That time they're trying to push the ball into Kilborn, and I think the idea is they're going to try to get Billy Goodell in foul trouble. That's his first. teams first. Both teams with one team foul here early on. 4:22 to go in the first quarter. Score 4-3. Low scoring ball game early on. Sock usually comes out and lights it up early.
Gilborn puts it in. He'll get another. 4:22 left, first period. Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week brought to you by Susquehanna Health System Sports Medicine Center, home of our coaches' corner early. And the pregame is we're tied at 4-4, getting you back in the game sooner. We're going to take a quick timeout. It'll be a 30. We'll pause for Subway. They've got the new patented toaster oven from Subway. Check it out. We're tied at 4.
Wait till you hear what we see. At Teleflex Communication Systems, we see a whole new generation of digital phones. Smaller, more powerful, smarter, and easier to use than ever. With sound so clear, our customers can hardly believe their ears. If you're looking for something to help you manage your business and your life a little more smoothly, what do you see the integrated phone and voicemail systems we just got from Samsung? Better yet, what do you hear them? Teleflex Communication Systems, locally owned and operated since 1986. Wait till you hear what we see.
Fairfield for Fair Deals, Fairfield Game of the Week. Tied at 4, CI had to make an adjustment early. Hughesville playing them tough defensively, doing a good job. Dotris, Will Kelly into the ball game. Here comes Corey over the timeline. Trying to free up that outside shot. They try to free up in that motion offense. Short with a three, the putback carry. Kelly crashes the boards. It won't come down. Kilborn's got his third rebound of the night. Hegley the other way. Yes, pretty play. Big bucket for a 6-4 Spartan lead. Great transition off the rebound by Kilborn, and a quick Dan Hegley beats him down for two.
All right, Will Kelly comes into the ballgame. That's one advantage that Ronnie Ensinger has. Billy Goodell picks up that one foul. They're attacking him inside. He's got Kelly to go to. A lot of depth. Another block inside. I think it was Kilborn again. He's having a great game.
Kilborn leads in blocks. Great job. Down the lane. Dotris. Follow Kelly is good. Again, you can see what the job that 6'2" junior forward Jordan Kilborn plays in the middle, because he'll swat those shots out of there. And a good job that Sock played with it and tied it at 6-6. Here's Egley coming out to the high post. Janer feed it down. Baseline shot by Kilborn goes down. Pretty play. Jordan Kilborn having a big night early for a 2.86 lead. He's got 6 of the 8 points.
Obvious Nick Tagliaferri's game plan coming into the ball game. Pound that ball into the low post. Get it to Kilborn. Make the big men defending. He's got one foul on Billy Goodell, one foul on Will Kelly. That's the second team foul against Loyal Sock. Kilborn will once again go for the foul line. He had two early, hit both of them. As a matter of fact, he has 6 of the 8 points for the Spartans here tonight.
Kilborn to the line, converts. Big bucket, 3-point play. 9-6, scoring this ball game. 3-point lead, Hughesville. Kilborn's got 7. Here's Kelly. He'll take it end to end. Whistle. Partially blocked, but got him with a body. Dan Hegley the foul. Team fouls are even at 2-2. You're watching Thursday night at 7. And Sunday morning at 10 here on Suscom Channel 2. Game brought to you in part by Rizzo Productions. That's right, the Riz putting together a professional highlight tape that your son and daughter in sports, football, basketball, even past athletics, if you've got it on film, video, DVDs, he puts together a highlight DVD with graphics, music, and more. Great for recruiting. Great just as a keepsake to have around forever. Great quality that'll last forever. Give them a call, 322-3298. RizzoProduction.com. Check it out. Great for the high school season. A lot of these athletes you see out here already have contacted them at Rizzo Production about getting a highlight DVD.
Will Kelly hits the second of two.
9-7 score of the game. Cody Webb in the ball game for Hughesville. Webb's got the ball. He goes low. Won't go. Hustle, rebound, Kilborn. A whistle, foul inside Kelly. Kilborn goes to the free throw line. As Lancer's starting to get some new people in the ball game right now.
All right, that's two fouls on Will Kelly. And again, they're pounding into that low post, getting it to Kilborn.
Eric Gattano's into the ball game. Gattano's in there right now. And Other players, Corey Steiger has come in the ball game too. Lancers very deep. They'll go at least 10 deep. Gilborn's having a big early start. He's got 8 of the 10 points and a 10-7 lead for Hughesville. Coming in 10-6, playoff bound.
Boy, Kilburn just burning the nets tonight. He's 6-for-6 from the foul lines, hit a couple from the floor. He has 9 of the 11 points that the Spartans have. Spartans up 11-7, 2:30 to go here in the first period.
11-7 game. Hughesville thus far 5 out of 5 as a team at the line right now. Yeah. It's 11-7 score in this ball game.
And the Lancers, who usually they shoot 74% from the foul line, have missed a couple here early on.
Jumper put down. Eric Atano knocks it down. A big bucket for the Lancers to cut it to 1, 11-10.
That's a weapon the Lancers have that really benefits their play. They fall behind. They can hit a three. You hit threes, it puts you right back in the ball game quick. They're down by 1.
They also get a guy like Dockers and some of those players on the bench, get them fresh like Nate Disher, and then give them a breather and have quality guys like their bench come in with Steiger and Gaetano and Will Kelly to come in to give these guys a breather. That's what makes Loyal Sock Coat tough when you've got to play four quarters.
That's right.
11-10, Lancers down by 1. Hughesville trying to pull the upset. Play them tough at Hughesville last time they played back December 21st. 73-59, Lancers pulled away at the end. Tyler Volpe in the ball game. On that left side, Gaetano on him. 151 first period. Little low feed, kickback. Leitcher won't go down. Hustle, rebound on the floor. Try to come down with it. Let's look and see. Coming down with the basketball is going to be Adam Shaner.
The game for the Spartans, 21-25.
Adam Shaner at number 35, 6 foot, 275-pound junior forward, is in the ball game right now. 11-10 after the turnover there. Sock gets it back.
All right, so far the Spartans have played really good defense, and that's what's kept them in that ballgame. There's another almost steal right there. Yeah, good call, good call. The officials, the official on it, Bobby Lynn, couldn't see it. He got blocked out, didn't know who it was. It did go off of Hughesville. It was a good hustle by Mike Leitcher, but he knocked the ball out of bounds. Gary Whiteman, the official on the other side, picked it up, made the right call.
Down low, Carey in traffic, turns, whirls, spins, and hits. Big bucket, Pat Carey. 12-11, Sock regains the lead. Hughesville using some of their bench in there right now. Egley taking away Goodell. Lead pass, Gaetano up the lane. Yeah, pretty play. Just like that. Great strip, Goodell. Great feed, Gaetano. He's come off the bench for 5. It's 14-11.
All right, Lancers, or Spartans have to protect the ball better than they did in that last trip up court.
That time, good denial that time inside to knock it away.
They did not take care of the basketball. Gave a cheap turnover away to Loyal Sock, and Loyal Sock converts those into points quick.
Jumper no good. Pulled down. Rebound Goodell. Here comes Dottris. Has great vision. Disher. Kick back. Corey sets the offense. Gaetano feeding the big guy. He's going to turn. Spin. Shot won't go. Got him with the arm. Kilborn will get the personal foul as he tried to take on a guy with a little bit longer reach at 6'2". But Kilborn using that body, doing a good job inside as they're trying to front and back Goodell inside. That time got him with the arm. 14-11 score of the game.
There's a shot of Billy Goodell at the foul line. 6'8", only a junior. Great touch on the ball. Hits the front end of 2.
24, he staggered, number 35.
Just like that, Sock has regained the lead and taken a 4-point lead at 15-11. This was a Hughesville team that had them down 11-7. It's been an 8-point run for Sock. Second won't go down. 15-11 Sock, 35 of the clock, first period. Fairfield Auto Group game of the week.
Lancers shoot as a team 74% from the foul line. Boy, they're not anywhere near that here tonight. You're about 50%.
Coming out high, that's Adam Shaner. Head of the circle, playing catch, Taylor Volpe. Needs some help, that's Priest. He gives you about 10 a game. lost the handle, kicked away, bump, whistle, foul, Hughesville. We come back the other way. As Steiger hit the deck, they pick up the foul down here against Hughesville, and it will be team foul four with 4 seconds left. First quarter of what turned out to be a low-scoring game, and now they're picking the pace up. Foul that time is going to go against Adam Shaner.
That time, Fulp lost a handle and another turnover.
Dontrus doesn't get it off in time. That's it. That's the end of one. We'll pause for Subway. Low fat, low carb. They've got it at the Williamsport Subway. 15-11 Loyal Sox. We'll be back. 15-11.
At Fairfield BMW, we offer one of the area's finest selections of new and certified pre-owned BMWs. And with Fairfield's reputation for fair deals, quality service, and complete customer satisfaction, there's just no reason to go anywhere else. What's more, at Fairfield BMW, we always have the best prices around, so you can be sure you'll drive away knowing you got a great deal, a Fairfield fair deal. Now is the time to buy that BMW you've been looking for. And at the Fairfield Auto Group, we've got you covered.
The sign you choose will identify you. It's a potential customer's first impression and the image that will remain with them. 21st century design signs to fit your image, and we manufacture them at our state-of-the-art facility. We offer installation and maintenance for all types of signs to ensure you make the best impression possible on the public. Your sign is your identity. It's your image and what your customers will remember. Your image is too important to leave to just anyone. Let the specialists at 21st Century Signs help you create and maintain your image.
Fairfield for Fairdale's Fairfield Game of the Week. Gary Christman and Babe Mayer. Loyal Sox Lancer Gym, a 16-1 Lancer team. Up by four. Hughesville's giving them all they can handle early. Alone, Shaner got up there, gets fouled. And I believe they're going to look at Pat Carey inside. Adam Shaner off the bench. And he'll get a chance at a two-shot foul. This is a ball club that jumped out to an 11-7 lead based on some great inside play by Jordan Kilborn, who had 8 early points. And all of a sudden, a 4-point lead. Then Sock went in an 8-point swing. That's where we are now at 15-11. Shot won't go down. Hughesville 10-6 coming in. And, you know, you take common opponents. Central beat Sock. This is a ball club from Hughesville that has beaten Central Columbia the last time they beat them, and beat them badly, 50-34, to give you an idea when you put common opponents together.
I missed both foul shots. That's not good. Hughesville's got to hit those.
Good denial. Egley, steal, big player down there. Here comes Shaner. Giving it away to Treese. That's Andrew Shaner. Blacher on that left wing. Treese. At 6'2", senior guard, 10 points per game. Nothing going there. They come back to Treese. Shaner turns, pivots, lost the handle. He'll go again and put it up over Goodell. It will not go down. Doctor has pulled down the rebound. Corey runs it up with 7 seconds. And now they do a little dance number at midcourt. Couldn't get out of the way. A whistle and a foul against Adam Shaner. This game brought to you in part by Orlando's Main Street Muncie. Old world charm, no longer the best kept secret for great food in Muncie, PA. It is worth the drive, and I'll tell you what, great original Italian cuisine, fine cuisine, great place after the game to grab a sandwich, and their signature penne, their signature tenderloin, pork tenderloin, and more at Orlando's. Shot wouldn't go, kept alive, McLean. Dotris up the lane, jumper. Goodell follows, yes. Good 6'8", 17-11, a 6-point lead, their largest of the game. Billy's got 6.
I tell you what, Billy Goodell, great rebound followed by a tough shot. Made it fall.
Hughesville doesn't want to get back too far in this game. Sock made the adjustments they needed when they fell behind early. There's a turnaround fadeaway shot won't go by Tony Webb.
Right now the Spartans getting beat on the boards.
Dincher, offensive. aggressive charge. That time setting himself, Andrew Shaner. I don't think C.I. thought he was set, but he gets the offensive foul as he hits the deck. We'll walk back down the other way. Team fouls even at five apiece.
The Spartans have got to get back on the scoreboard here. They led when they were at 11, haven't scored since. They're down by six as the Lancers have run off eight straight points.
21st Century Sign game update. Kilbourne with 9 points, four rebounds in that first period. Goodell had three and four rebounds. Steele Kelly. Here comes Dotrice, six-point Lancer lead. They've shut McLean down today, have not given him a shot. He leads his team with 14-2, but gave you 30 against Lewisburg when he was on fire and a school record eight threes. McLean forces the action. Put back, Goodell, pretty play. 19-11, an eight-point lead.
They get a timeout out of Hughesville.
That's a great replay we'll want to see again, a great example of how good he's gotten. We're going to take a short timeout for Subway. Remember, they've got that new toaster oven. Cold subs are hot at Subway. Lancers by eight.
Your insurance agent should be a friendly face that you can stop by and talk to. No one knows that better than the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn. Since 1932, the Wilkinson Dunn Company has been proudly serving local families, homeowners, and businesses. Our staff lives, works, and volunteers in your community. As an independent agent and trusted choice representative, we offer all types of insurance from a variety of respected insurers. And our focus is always on you, the customer. When it comes to insurance, come to your local professionals, the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn.
Fairfield game of the week, Fairfield for fair deals. Eight lines of cars, four great locations, great deals in the 05s now. You've got to check out that freestyle at Fairfield Ford and the great new Ford 500, the great new sedan. Get it all-wheel drive. Check it out at Fairfield. Sock by eight, 19-11. Kilbourne needs the ball. He was hot early. Partial block, good defensive play right there as Goodell not only gets the rebound, but the outlet away. He's become such a force for Lancers, yeah, in the middle.
Yeah, he's dominating the boards on both ends. That's his eighth rebound. He has 7 points, eight rebounds, and we still have 5 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Will Kelly puts it on the floor. Good steal, good takeaway that time for Hughesville. Heads up play that time by Cody Webb. Here's a kickback. Jumper will go in. Pretty play. Taylor Volk.
That's the first scores that the Spartans have had in the last 4 minutes of the ball game. They finally break that ice at 11.
Up the lane, Dotrice. That's Taylor Volpe. I don't want to put too much emphasis on Volpe as far as the pronunciation, not to make it sound Spanish. Dick Mason is our man that's good with pronunciations up here. So Taylor Volpe. So Taylor, we'll get your pronunciation correct up here. 19-13 score of the game, 4:36 left second period.
That Richie Mason's a versatile guy, isn't
he, Gary? I was unsure and didn't get a chance to check on the pronunciation. Dick Mason came through for us. He got on the phone downstairs to the Hughesville bench and got me the correct pronunciation. So we spare little expense when we've got Richie Mason up here.
That's right. He's our multi-purpose man. He's our utility man up here.
He's waiting in the wings for a play-by-play slot before it's all over.
Because he wants my job, in other words.
No, he doesn't want your job. He wants to be the next Tom Lodge.
Oh.
Good heads-up play. Will Kelly gets down there. Ball gets knocked away.
Good hustle.
Good heads-up play by Hughesville. They'll get it back.
Good hustle by Will Kelly. Stepped out of bounds, though, in the attempted steal.
Backs in, turns left, spins, banks, nothing. Couldn't get it over Carey. Gitano got it away to Dotrice. There's McLean free for three. Won't come down. Kelly heads up. Offensive board kept it alive for Loyal Sock. Gives him the ball back again. He's right. Such a force, Will Kelly, coming off that bench.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the Lancers are just dominating the boards, and that's not good for the Spartans.
Pat Carey. Kelly the putback. Kelly draws the foul. 20-13, Loyal Sock. 3:54 left, first half of this basketball game. Brought to you by AAA, most trusted name in travel. January is Disney month. Great discounts and specials with AAA. And they also remind you, our Vegas trip with the Crispin Show coming up It is May 2nd through 6th, starting at $6.99. Give them a call at AAA, 323-8431. AAA, the most trusted name in travel. Go with us to Vegas coming up. Kelly, four offensive rebounds in this game.
I tell you, the Lancers are 5 for 9 from the foul line. Kelly, a 74% free throw shooter, I think is 1 for 4.
Kelly puts it in, 21-13. Lancers build an 8-point lead. And, you know, they've come out, they've really done a number because they have outscored this ball club 14-2 in the last run after they trailed by 4. Then Hughesville sneaks free for a bucket. Taylor Volpe puts it in, 21-15.
Hughesville keeps it to a 6-point game. Now, Hughesville's got to get some rebounds. Right now, Loyalsock just dominating the boards, not playing real well offensively.
Jumper Kelly won't go. Ball's kicked away.
Foul's going to go against Gattano coming over the back. That'll be the 6th team foul against the Lancers. Next one will put Hughesville on the bonus. Lancers already in the bonus.
21-15 score in this ballgame. 3:27 until halftime. Coming up, J.P. Stone Granite Marble Halftime Show. The Granite guy, Joe Lovarno. The home of the kitchen, Extreme Kitchen Makeover. Foul against Gattano that time. Hughesville get a chance to go to the line. And again, Spartans in this deal, even though all of a sudden Lancers went on a 14-2 run. Hughesville wants to keep this ball game tight, keep the scoring down, and remain within striking distance, because you can see when they get in their rhythm and playing great D, they give Loyalsock all they can handle in this ball game.
Well, you know, there's no doubt about it on the scoreboard. This is one of those hang-around games, Gary. You're absolutely right. Hughesville's got to hang around. They're hanging their hat right now on defense, and when you're doing that, you got to pick up points at the foul line, which they failed to do right there. Missed the front end of a one-on-one.
Well, they're 5 of 8. They were 5 for 5 early. They missed their last 3 at the line in key situations. Here's Dotrus. Penetrates up the lane, then pulls it out. Gattano goes into the motion. Kelly against the man-to-man. Shaner on him. Into the circle. Dotrus feeds in the middle. Good denial. Egley got a piece of it. Away Lecher. Did they get the walk? Yes, they did. Although, I believe that time Volpe thought he was maybe hit from behind, but turned it over. It's going to be their 6th of the ball game. Hughesville loses a big opportunity there.
They sure did. Good hustle, though, by Nate Dincher on defense.
And Gattano missed the 3. He's got 1 already. Late to the rebound. Hughesville trying to cut the lead. Great lead pass up the lane. Pretty play. They got free to Dan Egley. That's a great pass by Andy Shaner.
All of a sudden on offense, great ball movement by the Spartans. Good sharp passes. They picked up a couple of baskets. They're down by 4.
21-17, Goodell backs in, turns, whirls, he walked, took steps. Good job backing him up that time as Egley trying to not give up much ground, and Lancers turn it over the 6th time of the ball game.
Well, I tell you what, Billy Goodell got a break there with the walk, because that could have well been called an offensive player possession foul. He really came back hard into the defensive man and pushed him backwards. So he walked before that occurred, otherwise that would have been a foul.
Egley, great move against Goodell, and Goodell still recovered to get a piece of the ball. Away, Gattano got it to Kelly, who got down too far. Loyalsock gets it back. This game brought to you in part by Teleflex Communications. Phone solutions that really do work for your business at home since 1986. Teleflex Communications.
2:07 to go here in the 2nd quarter. 4-point ball game. Lancers up 21-17.
Gattano. Outstanding young player coming off the bench for Loyalsock. Gives him a lot. McLean, they've really been in McLean's face in this ball game. Mike McLean is their leading scorer. He's got nothing. Has not scored yet. And they're giving him good defense all night long. Doing a little switching there. Nate Discher free. 3 won't go.
A good defense by the Spartans is forcing the Lancers to hurry their shots.
Lecher with a minute and a half. Turning it right back over. 2-on-2, McLean. Gattano in a crowd. Hits, he's fouled. Big bucket. Eric Gattano's got 7. He's having a big first half.
Yeah, Eric Gattano came off the bench, and man, has he had a good ball game here tonight. That's 7 points and goes to the foul line to try to make it 8, but he scored in some critical situations.
Big bucket, 23-17, score in this game. with a minute 26 until halftime with the J.P. Stone Granite Marble Halftime Show coming up. And the answer to Bay Bears, who is he and where is he now? He'll put it in, big bucket, back to 7, 24-17.
So many weapons for the Lancers. Gaetano's a hot gun tonight. Billy Goodell had a great first quarter.
Hughesville would like to keep it to 5 or under. Backing in. Gilmore wants the ball. They shut him down in the second period. Not that time. He goes back up, hits the shot. He's fouled. He's got 11 points. Looking for number 12 in a three-point play.
CI
didn't like that now, down in there.
I'll tell you what, I thought that was a good call. Kilbourne did a great job of getting in position, went up. Kelly went up as best he could, caught him with the body, and you're going to get that call.
24-19. Kilbourne having a big first half of this game, looking for his 12th point. Lancer Lunatics have not had a lot to yell about yet tonight. They love those games like the Hughesville game, like the Lewisburg game and the Millionaire game the other night, where the Lancers come out, put some big defense on, and pull away. But not tonight. Hughesville won't let them get away, but Hughesville has not helped themselves in the first half at the line in key situations.
No, they haven't. They haven't.
They're down by 5.
They're playing great defense, and that's what happens in this ball game. Offensively, not as great.
Goodell. Jumper won't go from 15. Heads up play, Dincher. Got the ball back, powered in and hit. 26-19.
Nate Dincher's one of those swing men. He comes under the basket. He's tough. He gets rebounds, gets putbacks. That was a big one right there. Lancers by 7.
Colby comes down. Jumper won't go. Goodell buries the rebound. Lancers try to get a bigger lead at halftime. Gaetano's helped him off the bench. He's got 7.
Big problem for the Spartans right now. They're one and done on offense. They're getting no offensive rebounds.
Down to 17 seconds till halftime. Lancers playing for the shot. McLean finds the lane. He's going to be fouled before he goes down. And they will shoot 1-1 the rest of the way. They're a team foul number 8 at this stage of this ballgame, or will they? Will they be in the bonus? Yeah, they will be. They are both in the bonus at this stage. It'll be team foul number 9 against Hughesville, 26-19 score in the game. You do not want to put Mike McLean at the free throw line. He's been shut out early, has not scored a point. He's 75% free throw shooter on the year, averages 14-2 a game. His high for the year, 30, a career high with 8 threes, a school record, week and a half ago against Lewisburg. Shot goes down, gets another. Lancers trying to get a 10-point lead or better by the half. 27-19, that ironically their largest lead at 8. Second shot goes, 9-point lead.
So far, the Spartans done a good job of not giving McLean a look at the basket. He's not gotten many shots off. That's his first real look.
Egley with 4 seconds. Short. Goodell the rebound. That's it. Lancers pull a 9-point lead at halftime and a good flurry at the end. Ups that lead against a pesky good defensive effort by Hughesville. Hold the Lancers low in scoring. They're used to scoring more than that at the half. We will take a quick timeout. Subway. Remember, Subway has the new patented toaster oven. Cold subs are hot and they're great this time of the year at a Subway near you. Golden Strip, Newberry, Southside, and like Cumming Mall, Steve Reed Subways. 28-19. J.P. Stone Halftime Show's next.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the court right now.
It's not the Autobahn, but for Volkswagen drivers, Route 220 can be just as fun. It's the way Volkswagen handles, the way it hugs the road and handles the curves. It's the way Volkswagen makes merging more rewarding and passing more of a power trip. And while the Autobahn might be an ocean away, Fairfield Volkswagen is just a short trip down Route 220 in Montoursville. So hurry to Fairfield Volkswagen in Montoursville and see what's happening this week. For Volkswagens, think Fairfield. Drivers want it.
Welcome to Vanderlyn Gallery and Custom Framing. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Christman. You know, one of the best ways of preserving your son or daughter's sports career is by framing their memorabilia. Whether it's a varsity letter, a jersey, or medals, it's something they're going to cherish forever. Or maybe there's something you'd like to preserve. I had some of my Sports Illustrated covers framed. Vanderlyn Gallery features work from many artists working in a variety of mediums. For the framing of sports memorabilia, a piece of fine art, or a print, there's Vanderlyn Gallery and Custom Framing. The Sports Medicine Center of the Divine Providence Hospital campus of Susquehanna Health System is the area's only comprehensive care center for sports injuries. Accessible care is easy with our team of board-certified orthopedic surgeons, certified athletic trainers, and physical therapists. Our dynamic physical therapy department uses a unique hands-on approach. The Sports Medicine Center offers an outreach athletic training service to regional high schools and colleges. The Sports Medicine Center of Susquehanna Health System, the best comprehensive care to get you back in the game. Get a taste of the old world charm at Orlando's Main Street Muncie, no longer the best kept secret in Muncie, PA. Since 1962, they've evolved in one of the finest restaurants in all of central Pennsylvania. It's a great atmosphere for quiet dining for two or bring all the family and friends. Of course, they're known for their authentic Italian cuisine and so much more, like Greco-Roman penne and Dad's homemade ravioli and their signature pork tenderloin. For lunch or dinner, make it Orlando's Main Street Muncie.
Your insurance agent should be a friendly face that you can stop by and talk to. No one knows that better than the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn. Since 1932, the Wilkinson Dunn Company has been proudly serving local families, homeowners, and businesses. Our staff lives, works, and volunteers in your community. As an independent agent and trusted choice representative, we offer all types of insurance from a variety of respected insurers. And our focus is always on you, the customer. When it comes to insurance, come to your local professionals, the insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn.
J.P. Stone, Granite Marble, halftime show, Gary Crispin and Babe Mayer, Loyal Sox, Lancers lead by 9, 28-19. Hughesville came out, played him good defense, and actually jumped to an 11-7 lead based on great play inside by Jordan Kilbourne, who ends up with a big first quarter, and ended up the first quarter, had 8 points early. Kilbourne in this ball game right now has got 11 total points in the game, and they jumped out to a four-point lead. 11-7. Lancers then went on a 14-2 run to build it to 21-13. And then Hughesville cut the lead. They battled back. And now Lancers bases a good play at the tail end of the last minute, build it up to 9 points at halftime. But Hughesville playing them good defense.
Well, Hughesville's playing great defense, but they're getting killed in the boards. And that's the difference in this ball game so far in the first half. Out-rebounded overall 25-14. That's almost double in behalf of the Lancers. But what's even more impressive is 10 offensive rebounds, a lot of those put back for points by the Lancers, to one for the Spartans. Spartans got to get on the boards if they're going to be in this ball game in the second half.
Yeah, Kilbourne was a huge key early in the game, had 11. Egli and Volpe right now with 4 points in the game. Loyal Sock had 7 out of Billy Goodell, a huge force inside. And Mike McLean had 2 at the free throw line. He was shut down. And Eric Gattano did a great job, ended up with 8 points off the bench. And a key play off the bench, the depth by Loyal Sox certainly gives them an advantage. We'll take a timeout. 28-19, our score at halftime. This is the J.P. Stone Halftime Show. And once again, we're back here at J.P. Stone Granite and Marble with the Granite guy, Joe Lovarno, West Lincoln Avenue, Southside. Joe, congratulations. What a year you guys have had.
Yeah, it's been pretty crazy, Gary, with all the customers coming in, picking out different stones. We now have quadrupled our selection on exotic stones from all around the world, reaching people 200-mile radius from this place.
This is spectacular. You talk about the colors and the styles, and, you know, I even picked out mine here. No, I should say you picked it out. Joe picked it out. You know, I just had granite countertops put in my kitchen, and Joe said, here is what will work. This is perfect for your color, and, man, it was great. Great feedback I've had.
Yeah, your kitchen was probably one of the best ones for before and after of a one-day quick redo-over where you didn't have to spend a ton of money.
I'll tell you what, and it's great. Joe Lovarno, now you go computerized to make the work that much more efficient. Let's talk about it.
We spent close to $900,000 on machinery to make everything computerized, basically to get jobs out quicker, but primarily to ensure the customers that it's the best possible job done once it walks out of here. No man can match that kind of quality, not even myself.
I'll tell you what, let's go in and take it out and find out how this works out. All right, Joe, step number one is that much more state-of-the-art this year. Let's talk about some of the new equipment you have.
Well, Gary, what you're seeing here is an electronic templater that actually digitizes people's countertops so that it automatically turns it into a DXL file, and what that is basically what a computer can read. From here, all this information will get sent to the big machine out in the shop that we can go and check it out, and I can explain a little bit more out there.
All right, Joe, we're out here on the shop. What is step number two? What do we do next?
Step number two, Gary, is we'll actually bring the slab in that the customer chose, and the saw behind us is going to cut it in its rough form, And from there, it'll go onto the CNC machine, which is a totally automated machine. It does everything that we templated it with that laser in the showroom there. And then from the CNC machine, it will then go to the guys that will touch it up, make sure everything's right, clean it up, seal it several times before it goes to the customer's house, load it up on the A-frames, packed in a truck, and away they go to your house.
I'll tell you what, we're talking about taking your kitchen or bathroom to the next level. You really do with J.P. Stone, Granite Marble Joe. Congratulations on a great year and good luck in the future.
Hey, I appreciate that, Gary. Thank you.
I'll tell you what, customers really satisfied with J.P. Stone. Give them a call today, 323-ROCK, West Lincoln Avenue, South Side, J.P. Stone. You know, when you talk about great trips anywhere in the world, you've got to join AAA Travel. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Crispin here at Kailua Beach in Oahu. We're experiencing a great luau here. You can hear that in the background. Join AAA Travel no matter where it will be. Here in Hawaii, maybe Bermuda, the Caribbean for cruises, all inclusives to the Caribbean, great getaway weekend packages, even Europe. Give them a call today, 323-8431. AAA, the most trusted name in travel. I've got a luau to go to. Aloha.
Now that's a strong pool. Stop in and see the difference for yourself. Strong pools and spas are made by your friends down the road in Danville. You can see them locally right here on the Golden Strip. Strong Industries uses state-of-the-art manufacturing techniques to produce the highest quality spas and pools on the market today and then offer them to you at the factory direct prices. There is no doubt you can't beat the quality or the price. Strong Pool Outlet on the Golden Strip, Williamsport. You just can't beat a strong pool. Central PA's experienced personal injury law firm is Reeders, Travis, Humphrey, Harris, Waters, and Boffenschmidt. Call them today at 323-7683. Specializing in serious personal injury and death cases, state and federal courts, auto, motorcycle accidents, personal injury, wrongful death. Free consultation on personal injury cases. No recovery, no fee. Call them today, 323-7683. Their experience is on your side.
Was a 1998 Montgomery High School graduate that would set records in football and track in both high school and college? Well, if you said DJ Flick, you're correct. On a high school gridiron, he would set records for most touchdowns scored and total rushing yardage for a season and career. In track, he would win District 4 championships in the 100, 400, and long jump. He would go on to play wide receiver and run track at Slippery Rock University, where he'd become an All-American in both football and track. His Slippery Rock football team won 3 conference championships, aided by his play at wide receiver and his 10 kick returns for touchdowns, both a school and conference record. In his senior season, he would lead the nation in kickoff returns, averaging 39.9 yards a return. He would also lead the Slippery Rock Tracksters to 3 conference championships and would be named to the Division II All-American track team. Following college, he was drafted by the Pittsburgh Steelers and now plays professional football in Canada. In 2003, he led the Ottawa Renegades in pass receptions and touchdowns. In 2004, he was traded to the Hamilton Tiger Cats, where he led the Cats in touchdowns and into the CFL playoffs. In both 2003 and 2004, DJ was named to the Canadian Football League's All-Pro team. During the offseason, DJ works as a trainer at the Mayor Sport Training Center here in Williamsport, and this spring will marry his high school friend Mandy Hecknauer before returning to Hamilton for the 2005 season. DJ Flick, this week's Rennie Rod Armel All-State Insurance. Who is he and where is he now? Tune in next game for another Rennie Rod Armel All-State Insurance. Who is he and where is he now? And stay tuned for the second half of the ball game between the Lancers and the Spartans. We'll be right back.
The Rennie Rod Armel Agency has been providing a wide range of insurance products to your friends and family for the past 26 years. Whether you need auto, home, life insurance, business insurance, annuities, CDs, or long-term care insurance, the Rennie Rod Armel Agency wants to be your agent for life. We're conveniently located on Westminster Drive and the Penn Hills Plaza. Our friendly, helpful staff is available for all your insurance needs. Call Rennie Rod Armel Senior Insurance Agency today.
Go ahead, make my coffee. To satisfy the toughest customers, only the best tasting coffee will do.
Go ahead, make my coffee.
At Dunkin' Donuts, each and every pot is brewed fresh and served fresh at the peak of its flavor. If you're a tough customer, only the taste of this coffee will do. So go ahead, let Dunkin' Donuts make your coffee exquisite.
Indeed.
Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week, Gary Crispin and Babe Mayer after our J.P. Stone halftime show. Loyal Sock by 9. Second half action, Bill Goodell steps up, can't hit the baseline jumper. And here come the Spartans. Jumper by Shaner won't go. Goodell the rebound. That was the problem, is one and done. And that time, Lacher can't get out of the way of Corey Dotrice. And that happened the first half. Dotrice gets the ball up so quickly that he sometimes draws fouls at midcourt as guys are trying to get back up court. They run right back over him. Well, team foul number one against Lacher.
That time Lacher tried to go to the side, but Dotrice was moving to the same side, and that's what caused the collision.
28-19, Lancers going after their 17th. Playoff tune-up, Nick Tagliaferri's Spartans are 10-6. And lost to this team at Hughesville, 73-59, but played them tight to the end. When the Lancers finally pulled away, that's the game Kevin Dinger was injured in. He's still not playing tonight. They said there was a chance, but game by game, and there's McLean's first three of the game, his first field goal. He's got 5 points. The others were two free throws late in the first half, but answering at the other end, John Treese puts it down.
That was a big bucket by Treese. That was a 12-point lead on McLean's basket. Treese comes down, hits the three, brings it back down to 9.
That is his 25th three of the year. He shoots at nearly 40% from three-point range and put one down there to make it 31-22. Jumper won't go. Goodell stays with it. What about the game Chevy Troutman had the other night for the Pitt Panthers?
Wow, against UConn. Incredible.
Yeah, and I'm sorry I missed it. I was having a tough time getting out of the country of Mexico.
I'll tell you what, he put his name on the map if it wasn't already there in that game.
Good play. John Treese picks up the pace, comes out with 5 points by Treese in this period. 31-24, back to 7. Hughesville not going away.
All right, now Hughesville still got to get on the boards. They're getting no rebounds on the offensive end and not many on the defensive end. So they've got to hang in there on the boards.
Turnaround jumper, Goodell. Boy, does he look smooth on that play.
Billy Goodell has a great shot for a big man.
You know, the great thing about Goodell, he gets more aggressive, and he wants the ball. He comes out to meet the ball. He has that smooth jumper. Three-point shot won't go. Egli, great power offensive rebound. Puts it up and in. He's fouled. It counts. The foul against Goodell. Big bucket, Danny Egli.
That was a good play by Dan Egli. Good hustle. Got the offensive rebound. Got Goodell off balance, and Goodell commits the foul. That'll be his second. Both teams with one.
Here's a Fairfield replay. Big, big play there. Here's a look again.
Rare offensive rebound. Good job by Cleese. He's going to turn, and Billy Goodell gets him with the body going up.
Cuts it to a six-point game. Converts a three-point play. McLean up the lane. Yes. Oh, that left side cuts through and scores. He's got a quick 7, 35-27.
Good pull-up by McLean. He almost got the player possession foul. Did a great job of setting his feet, pulling up, and shortening that shot.
Here's Kilbourne. Good position, wouldn't go down, got it back up and puts it in. Good play, Jordan Kilbourne. He's got 13 in the ball game after that big 8-point first quarter. McLean, Hughesville led early by as many as 4. And then the Lancers went on a 14-2 run.
Good hustle by Dinger, saves the ball.
McLean, too far down. Hustle, Lacher comes out of the pack in number one. It was so tough for the Hughesville Spartans at running back. Runs it up over the timeline with a little under 5 minutes left third period. This Fairfield game of the week. Fairfield, the place to go for Toyota. Golden Strip, Williamsport. Kilbourne, Powers, reverse layup won't go. Dotrice, Dinger. Foul going up. We mentioned Fairfield for fair deals. Fairfield Toyota on the Golden Strip, the home of 5 different Toyota SUVs. And completely new look in some of their great 05 vehicles. You want to check it out. Check out that Toyota Tundra, one of the hottest trucks gone. Fairfield Toyota on the Golden Strip. Great deals remaining 04s, but incredible 05s at great prices. Check it out. Check with Dick Stive and the gang at Fairfield Toyota. 36-29.
That foul went against Dan Eggly. That'll be his third. Dincher hits the front end of two. Dincher, 75% free throw shooter. And this Lancer team is 74% overall. They're going to drop a little bit tonight, but just a tremendous free throw shooting team. Dincher hits the back end and picks up 2 points.
Dincher puts that down, and you're right. You see a ball club stepping up the line, hit nearly 75% as a team. You don't want them at the line. 8-point lead Lancers. Hughesville looking to cut it back down. Spin, Eggly, short, got his own rebound, again draws the foul. So Eggly coming to play in this third period. Big free throws here. Hughesville at the line on the night, 6 out of 10. Lancers are 11 of 15.
That's going to be the third foul against Billy Goodell underneath.
This ball game brought to you in part by Vanderland Gallery, where they've got great deals, 10 to 50% off everything in their art gallery and 20% off memorabilia framing, including sports memorabilia framing. You know, take all the keepsakes, the letters, the medals, the great team pictures, action photos in from your past playing days, your kids' playing days. Get them done. It's a great keepsake. They do a great job with 20% off that at Vanderland Gallery. Tell them you saw it right here. 37-29, score in the game.
Spartans miss another foul shot. Can't do that. Can't do that in a ball game like this.
No, not when you're playing sock at the Lancer Gym. Gattano sneaks in for a two more. He's got 10 of the night. He had 8 off the bench early. 39-29.
Big assist by Stagger.
10-point lead. Sock, that is their largest lead of this night. They just wear you down with depth. Guys like Gattano coming off the bench. Will Kelly and Steiger and people like that can do a great job.
Both teams with a small lineup on the floor here. 3:53 to go.
Volpe with the basketball. He had 4 in that first half off the bench. Gattano got the rebound. Nobody down there to pull the rebound down.
Rebounding's been the Achilles heel of the Spartans. They've got to get on the boards if they're going to get in this ballgame.
Gattano looking low into that motion. Setting up the three for Dotrice, who looked low. Lacher came out, denied the shot. And now they're trying to be patient here and look for the good open shot here. Kelly. Eggly on him and the man-to-man. Adam Shaner of the game, 35. There's a jumper. Good pass. Kelly can't hit it. McLean passed up the jumper. The great assist attempt, and Kelly draws a two-shot foul.
You put the Lancers on the foul line, 10-point lead, a chance to extend that. That's the third foul on Lacher. So fouls becoming a big issue. Still 3:15 to go here in the third. Billy Goodell with 3. He's on the bench. Lacher in the ball game with 3.
After the ball game, great place to go. Dunkin' Donuts with the new cappuccinos and lattes made with real espresso blend. Dunkin' Donut coffee voted number one favorite coffee in America. And all those great coffee rolls and donuts and more at Dunkin' Donuts, Golden Strip, and in Newberry. And by Blair Brothers Goldsmiths. John and Billy getting ready for Valentine's Day with a completely new line of jewelry. You want to check it out. They have restocked after a huge holiday season. Blair Brothers, get that for her for Valentine's Day. 41-29, Volpe, rejected by Steiger. Big block by Corey. 41-29, the Lancers starting to pull it away with 3:04 left third period.
All right, Volpe's got to pull the trigger on that. He saw the opening, hesitated, gave Steiger a chance to get over in position and block that shot.
Good hustle, away, Corey Steiger. Good defensive play with 3:01 left. Our next ball game, you're watching this game Thursday at 7, Sunday at 10, Suscom Channel 2. We'll be off this weekend, and then next weekend is time called by Hughesville. Nick Daglaferri and the gang going to get a, looks like a full timeout's going to be called. But we'll give you the update on our next games coming up, 41-29. Let's pause for Subway, and it looks like it's going to be a 30. Subway, the Williamsport area. Lancers are pulling away.
Hey.
talented, experienced, and outstanding craftsmen. These are words used to describe the goldsmiths at Blair Brothers. Exquisite gemstones and diamonds, unequal designs and incredible detail. These are words used to describe the jewelry at Blair Brothers Goldsmiths. Each goldsmith is passionate about the quality of their work. You'll realize a fresh new attitude paid to you and your jewelry. You'll be treated with respect and care, and your custom jewelry will show it. Experience the new artistry and fresh new attitude awaiting you at Blair Brothers Goldsmiths.
41-29, Hughesville needed the timeout. Greece, downtown shot for three, won't go. Hustle, rebound, Kilborn kept it alive, Volpe. Greece had a good start in this third period. Good to Niall Gattano. He's played a great game tonight. And here come the Lancers. 2:45 left third period of this Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week. McLean pulls up the jumper. Yes, pretty play. Big bucket there. He's had a big second half. He's got 9, 7 of those in the third period.
Lancers by 14, and the Spartans losing contact on the scoreboard. That's not good. When you're a defensive-oriented team, which they are here tonight, you can't afford to get that far behind.
Well, you know, you take a look at this ball club. This Spartan team has only scored 10 points in the second half of the game. As the Lancers up in that lead. They're led by 9 at halftime. Hughesville led early in that first period, led by 4. Then the Lancers went on a 14-2 run. Kilborn, good denial. Kelly in there took the shot away. Volpe, Treese, they've got to get somebody hot. Lancers keep bringing people in the ballgame. Danny Egli, Kilborn up the lane by Kelly. Partial block, Kelly. Kept alive. Egli again, yes, stayed with it. Good play the other side. Kelly, great play. Egli stayed with it and hit the bucket. They needed that, 43-31.
And once again, I got an offensive rebound and got a putback out of that. They've come far and few between.
McLean gets it shoveled from behind and out of bounds. They'll get it back with a minute 47 left. Fairfield Auto Group Game of the Week brought to you in part by Sports Medicine Center, Susquehanna Health System, campus at Divine Providence Hospital. Getting you back in the game sooner. Covering all over Central PA, including all the way to the Northern Tier. They do a great job at the Williamsport Hospital, and we should say the Sports Medicine Center, Susquehanna Health System at Divine Providence. Good block, good play. Shaner got a piece of it. But get back in the game sooner. Recreational athletes, high school, college, Little League World Series, Sports Medicine Center will get you there at SHS. Over that timeline, started the ball game. Brother Adam also playing here tonight. Baseline. Shaner back to Kilborn. 3 for 3. Downtown shot goes in. Good bucket off the bench. Cody Webb, the 5'11 junior forward that averages 7 points a game. Hits the 3 to draw within 9. They needed that.
Yeah, that was a big basket. Good defense by the Lancers. They just broke down there at the end and gave the man the 3. But other than that, they were on top of things.
Jumper McLean, foul of the act. You'll get the bonus shot at the free throw line. Foul of the act of the 3-point shot with 1:01 left in this third period. Fairfield Game of the Week.
McLean, a 75% free throw shooter. So you can't beat him. You foul him outside, you're going to put him on that line. He shoots well from the line, too.
Loyal Sock, 13 of 17 at the line. A team that shoots as a team, 75%. And McLean that shoots at an even 75% coming in. RizzoProduction.com. Check that number. Check that website or call them at 322-3298. Let the Riz and the gang put together Rizzo Production professional highlight sports team. Your highlight, your sports career, or of course your son or daughter, football, basketball, baseball, doesn't matter. You supply the videotapes, the film, or of course the in anything that you have, and of course they put together the DVD of the highlights, Rizzo Production. Dincher fades away and hits the 3. Got the right roll. 28-34 score in the ball game.
There's 5-point turnaround right there on the foul and Dincher's shot.
Hughesville having their problems now, just handling the Loyal Sox pressure. Treese with 35 in the clock. Lancers up by 14. The pump by Tree, shot won't go. Kilborn back up and in. Power rebound, stand within some distance, but stand within a little range of this team. 48-36, 17 in the clock here. But now they've lost 3 points from halftime, where they were down by 9. McLean with 10 seconds. Dinger, great feed. Kelly for, no, it won't go. Kilborn with 3. Treese, the shot counts. Banks in. What a shot, John Treese. It's good for 3. And they've cut it to a 9-point game. Hughesville's not gone away. John Treese. What a bucket put in by Treese with a big third period. We'll see it again in a moment. We'll pause for Subway. Subway, the Williamsport area, Golden Strip, Newberry, south side of the Lycoming Mall. Get that patented toasted oven hot sub now at Subway. We'll be back.
We guarantee it. Chevrolets and Cadillacs cost less at Fairfield.
We have the lowest prices, even free delivery.
So you can be sure you'll get a Fairfield fair deal.
Save on every Chevy on our lot. From Cavaliers to Trailblazers to Corvette.
In stock and ready to go.
How about a Cadillac Escalade or SRX?
We have the lowest prices around.
Even on hard-to-find pre-owned vehicles.
We've got you covered at Fairfield Chevrolet Cadillac.
No games, no surprises, just low, low prices on Chevrolets and Cadillacs.
With a fair deal at Fairfield in Lewisburg. Guaranteed.
Wait till you hear what we see. At Teleflex Communication Systems, we see a whole new generation of digital phones. Smaller, more powerful, smarter, and easier to use than ever. With sound so clear, our customers can hardly believe their ears. If you're looking for something to help you manage your business and your life a little more smoothly, what do you see the integrated phone and voicemail systems we just got from Samsung? Better yet, what do you hear them? Teleflex Communication Systems, locally owned and operated since 1986. Wait till you hear what we see.
What a shot a moment ago. Might have been about a 35-footer by John Treese. Banked it in from the left-hand side to cut it to a 48-39 ball game at the buzzer to end the third. Hughesville now can turn this into a 5-point play.
Oh, it's 4 against Billy Goodell. Not a good foul.
Big, big turnaround by Kilborn. Here's the replay look at a great shot at the buzzer by John Treese. It counted all the way. Here's the flurry up the other end. It will not go by Kelly. Kilborn got it away to Treese. He looked at the clock, let it go, and yes, it goes in. Great bucket. It counted, and now they've cut it to an 8-point game. 48-40. So what was a 14-point deficit at 48-34 has now become a 7-point game.
All right, Ronnie Anstey is going to try to get Goodell out of the ball game. He's got 4 fouls. He doesn't want to lose the big man. This game's not over.
7-point run, Hughesville. Carey. Dinger can't handle it. Dotris. McLean. Hughesville doing a good job switching men, helping out, trying to get some defense and denying the lane, denying that baseline.
Nick Tagliaferri has them hustling too. I'll tell you, fourth quarter and they are running.
Backdoor Goodell in traffic, yes! Big bucket Goodell! 3 men around him. Billy made the play for the reverse layup and the foul with 7:13 left, and they lift it back to 9.
Well, I want to tell you something. That was a great entry pass by Corey Datris. Great pass, got it under Goodell, goes in position. Little reverse, puts it off the backboard and gets it to fall. He'll go to the foul line, try to make it a 3-point ball game. So all of a sudden, that lead is starting to extend again. Back up to 9 points, a chance at 10.
Goodell's shot won't go for the 3-point play, but they lift it back to 9. Volpe brings it down for Hughesville. Treese. Shaner. Kilborn. Loyal Sock tightening the defense up. They've got Egley out of there right now. There's Kilborn. He's going to take Goodell to the hole. He goes up too hard. Hustle, rebound, Pat Carey. This is a great athlete, only a sophomore. McLean. Hangs, and it will not go, but fouled. He's got a two-point play. Here's a shot foul. Here is a great pass down low, this time to Billy Goodell.
All right, ball's going to come back out to the outside to Datris, and watch the entry pass. Look at him hit Billy Goodell. Good job. Little reverse layup there. Puts it off the backboard and in. Great entry pass by Gatra set up that play.
And it was a great give and go. Corey knew right where he was coming back to. Goodell on the side, got it back to Corey. He goes baseline, reverses it in. Could not hit the three-point play. That was a big bucket, though. And now it's back from 7 to a 10-point game, 51-41, as you look at the winningest coach in the area, C.I. Ron Ensinger. Doing it a lot of years. Guy's done a great job. You take a look at going for his fifth straight District 4 AA crown. And they were not favored to win the first couple of those. They've stuck up on people and then had the mark in their back and won the last two favored. 52-41 back to 12.
All right, you got to force the ball into Kilbourn right now. He's got a mismatch underneath. He's going against Carey.
Kilbourn, little head fake. Carey won't give room. Leitcher, the jumper, won't go down. Egley. Back to Danny Egley. Good spin. Won't come up with it. Too many white jerseys there, and Dotrice comes out with a rebound. Lancers just crashing the boards, 52-41. It's been a big key why they're leading this game. And a little double dribble, turned it over. McLean, some indecision, and they turn the ball over there. We'll walk back down the other way.
All right, you're getting down 5 or 6 minutes, just a little under 6 minutes to go in this ball game. The possessions are going to become important. You're down by 11. The Spartans are going to have to get some scores on these possessions early on.
Janer got it out. Kilbourn, loose ball picked up. Leitcher takes the jumper for three and comes it down. Big bucket as he puts it down. Mike Leitcher.
Had a fan on the far side that drew something to Leitcher. Leitcher turned around and said something. The young boy on the far side.
It's an 8-point game, 52-44 score in this ball game. Jumper, Dencher, yes. Nate Dencher has come to play in the second half. He's got 10 and a pair of threes.
So many weapons. He can score from so many positions with so many people. That's what makes it tough. You get a big basket out of Leitcher at one end. Dencher comes back to the other end, drains a three, answers, and then right away you're back up to 11-point lead.
55-44 score in this ball game. 5:16 left. Fairfield Auto Group game of the week. Fairfield Chevy Cadillac Lewisburg. You got to check them out. And Fairfield Honda Muncie. Egley. Shot won't go. Big miss. Will Kelly. What a hustle rebound. Dencher was already on the floor, and he gets up slowly. Dencher, and here come the Lancers.
Dencher did a great job on defense, though, in the paint to prevent that basket.
Kelly in traffic, hangs, and it won't go. Leitcher. Here comes Treese to hit that big three-pointer. The draw within nine at the end of three. Shaner. Kilbourn. Spins. Did he walk? He took steps. Good defensive work that time of Pat Carey. Just wouldn't give up the ground in that little indecision. He shuffled the feet, turned it over. That's their 11th in the ballgame. Sox got 8 turnovers.
All right, and you can't give up possessions like that.
McLean too far down, called timeout. Did do it in midair, and CI's got a quick timeout, preventing the turnover. 55-44. We'll take a Subway timeout. Subway, they've got them all. Subway in the Williamsport area. Low-fat, low-carb wrap salad subs at Subway. We'll be back. One of the best moves you can make this year is to have a highlight video of your child's season. Rizzo Productions can produce a professional highlight video of any season, any sport, past or present, with music, titles, and special effects. You can use the video as a recruitment tool for colleges or give it as a gift. Check the website, RizzoProduction.com.
It's your boy Main Event, Wally Dixon, from A1 ESPN Streetball. Every high school cat need a video. Check out Rizzo Productions, PA Sports Highlight DVD.
Fairfield game of the week, Rizzo Production. Give them a call, 322-3298, RizzoProduction.com. Get that highlight video, your son or daughter's athletic career, highlight for the season for college recruiting, or simply just as a keepsake to have around forever on great quality DVD with music and more. Dantris tries to pull the old inbound off the back trick, and it's going to be a Loyal Sox basketball right here. Thank you. McLean, Shaner, good defense. 4:30 to play. Hughesville has not gone away. Loyal Sox been trying to pull away. They had the lead up to 14, and then Hughesville got it down to 7 with a 7-point run. Sox has gotten it back to 11 with 4:18 left in this ball game. Taking a little time off, trying to be a little patient now. Gaetano, good man-to-man Hughesville. There will be a playoff team. Time called. Good defensive double team by Hughesville. We'll take another quick timeout for Subway. Golden Strip, Newberry, Southside, Light Coming Mall. There's a Subway near you. Sock by 11.
The sign you choose will identify you. It's a potential customer's first impression and the image that will remain with them. 21st century design signs to fit your image, and we manufacture them at our state-of-the-art facility. We offer installation and maintenance for all types of signs to ensure you make the best impression possible on the public. Your sign is your identity. It's your image and what your customers will remember. Your image is too important to leave to just anyone. Let the specialists at 21st Century Signs help you create and maintain your image.
Fairfield game of the week. Fairfield for fair deals. 55-44 score of this ball game with 4:04 left of this basketball game. Watching Thursday at 7, Sunday morning at 10, Suscom Channel 2 on our 18th season is the Fairfield game of the week. Gaetano, Sock, you'll see them again. Williamsport Showcase event February 5th against Athens. First of a doubleheader live on PCN. McLean for three. Won't go. Leitcher the rebound. Millionaires will play the night cap of that game against White Plains, New York. We'll have them both on Cable Sports, Suscom, and PCN Live Saturday night, February 7th, Channel 21 with Suscom. Jumper. Won't go down by Treese. Boy, do they need that shot there.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, you're not going to keep the Lancers from scoring, and the Lancers have the ability to run clock. These missed opportunities are going to put this game away real quick if they haven't already. 3:20 to go here in the ball game.
Here's a bump, Gaetano, left side, Kelly. Head of the circle, good defense, Hughesville, though. Nick Tagliaferri's got him playing. Little stutter step up the lane, Corey Hangs won't go. Treese, big possession here for Hughesville. Leitcher, the three. Kilbourne. It'll come out of bounds. It comes back to the Loyal Sox Lancers to get it back. Will it be the girls? Look and see. Hughesville is going to give it up, get back in defense. Lancers get it back.
All right, 30 seconds off the clock there. You come up empty. 11-point lead. This ball game just about over. Spartans played a great game, but just couldn't score on the offensive end. Give credit to the Lancers, played some good defense here in the second half.
Hughesville feels they still have some time, but they've got to come up with some key possessions. As Loyal Sox right now goes into their motion offense. Great play, great save, Kilbourne. Back to Kilbourne for no, it will not go down. Great play by Kilbourne, and then he missed the layup, and then there's a foul. And that is how close that would have cut it to a 9-point ball game. We might want to see that again. Kilbourne did a great job off the save, and then behind the back save. Back over here to Shaner. Back to Kilbourne, and then he came up short of the layup that would have cut it under 10 with 2:26 left in the ball game. Then they foul the other way. McLean, who is almost golden every time at the line.
All right, here's the steal. Good behind the back by Claiborne. Good entry pass. Claiborne just misses the shot. Billy Goodell there may have been a little intimidating. But the problem is, Gary, that they ran almost 40 seconds off the clock there and came up with nothing. The Lancers can run clock, and that's what kills you when you fall behind against them.
McLean to the line, won't go down. Whistle foul, it's who they're looking at. I think Will Kelly's going to pick it up. Lancers fifth team foul. Kelly picks up the personal foul. They're not in the bonus yet. Kilbourne inbound. They better hurry. Leitcher, an elbow, I think inadvertently, but McLean didn't like it. Leitcher pulled the elbow out, and they didn't get the call. And now a technical foul. It's called against C.I. Ron Ensinger. C.I. is very upset he didn't get a foul there, and now upset, and now he gave him two technicals, and C.I. is tossed, and that doesn't happen very often. Ron Ensinger feels clearly got a bad call, and C.I., who's a class guy, upset he didn't get an obvious elbow call there by Lacher, and then upset. Of course, it makes it worse when you're already off the bench, which is new in PIAA basketball. And then C.I.'s very upset at the technical. Gets a second tee, and he's having to leave the gym.
All right, a lot of shots here.
There was the elbow, and that was, well, I said inadvertently, and I think Lacher's idea was to pull it out there, and McLean got hit. Most times you're going to get that call. The Lancer fans not happy. Trees to the line again, and he gets one of them.
All right, he gets two more now. There was two.
That's
technicals.
Right, two technicals. You're going to get two more. 55-45 ball game. Second goes in.
All right, now, you know the Lancers play a tight defense. They get on you, all right, and you clear out. I mean, that could have been called, but I didn't think that was really that bad a call by the official. I think Ronnie Ensinger was trying to make a statement. And then when he got the first foul, got caught up in it and gets ejected from the game. 2:18 to go.
55-47, Hughesville trying to make this happen. Volpe, Kilborn. Volpe for three. Kilborn, power rebound, back up, no good. Put back Egli, yes! Big bucket, Dan Egli. And they cut it to a 55-49 game with 2:01 left and still a ball game. Don't go away yet. Here's Venture.
All right, got to play some defense now. Lancers can run clock, and that's what's going to kill you in this situation. Under 2 minutes.
Anything can happen. They had an 11-point lead a while ago, but that was still striking distance, and then you didn't count on two technicals. Here's Kelly. Whistle, bump, foul.
That's going to be a shooting foul. They're in the bonus. Going to go against Egli. That'll put Gatris at the foul line.
Time call, Nick Tagliaferri. This is a full timeout. We'll pause for Subway. Low fat, low carb. Lose that weight. Eat healthy. Well, like Jared at Subway. Lancers lead it by the only lead by six. We'll be back.
Insurance for your home, for your family, for your life, for your business. The insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn are here for you. Our staff lives, works, and volunteers in your community, and we are proud of the personal, high-quality service we provide. We are a local independent agent, and that allows us to serve you first and find you the most competitive rate. Home, auto, business, life, and health. When it comes to insurance, make the best choice, the trusted choice, the faces you know, the service you deserve. The insurance people at Wilkinson Dunn Company.
You know, when you talk about great trips anywhere in the world, you've got to join AAA Travel. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Christman here at Kailua Beach in Oahu. We're experiencing a great luau here. You can hear that in the background. Join AAA Travel no matter where it will be. Here in Hawaii, maybe Bermuda, the Caribbean for cruises, all inclusives to the Caribbean. Great getaway weekend packages, even Europe. Give them a call today, 323-8431. AAA, the most trusted name in travel. I've got a luau to go to. Aloha.
It is a 55-49 basketball game. A double technical back-to-back against C.I., who's now left the gym. And now the Lancers try to hang on for their 17th. Give a new life to Hughesville, 56-49. On a little bit of a controversial no call on an elbow by Lacher against McLean. C.I. got upset, got the tee, and then couldn't believe he got a tee on it. On what he thought was a bad no call, and then got the second, giving them a couple of free throws, and then Trees comes down to answer to cut it to 57-51. They come down here right away and foul. Although when you foul anybody that wears a maroon and white jersey, they don't miss very often. But right now, Hughesville knows with a miss, we need to come down and convert. John Treese has had a big second half
in this basketball game. 13 points in the second half of this game. And he had one at the buzzer at the tail end of the third period that backed in from 35 feet.
All right, Lancer's in the double bonus right now. That was a 10th team foul against Hughesville. Dacris, an 85% free throw shooter.
Yeah, he's a guy you don't want at the line. This guy, he's just solid.
And when you're a point guard, you got to be able to shoot free throws because they're gonna get you.
20 out of 27 makes it look easy. Lifts it to us an 8-point lead. 59-51. Golby's shot won't go. Goodell, they reach in and foul. And now the Lancers get to go to the free throw line where they shoot nearly 75% as a team the remainder of the way.
Billy Goodell's played well in this fourth quarter with four fouls. He's protected himself.
This ball game brought to you in part by Orleans. That's right, Orlando's Main Street Muncie. Boy, they've continued to renovate over the years, 40-plus years. No longer the best-kept secret in Muncie, PA. Great old-world charm, outstanding food. And, of course, when Jeff and I did the commercial, we had that signature dish, Greco-Roman penne. Dad's homemade ravioli, a great. And, of course, their signature pork tenderloin. Great place for a sandwich after a game or go there for lunch. Orlando's Main Street, Muncie. It is well worth it. Check it out. 61-51. 10-point lead with a minute 15 left. Treese, short for three. Save, but out of bounds off Lacher. Sock with the ball and a 10-point lead. And eyeing their 17th.
All right, full court pressure.
Assistant coach Danny Stopper is up coaching now. McLean for an easy two, and that should do it. 63-51 with a minute four left. Lacher baseline. Goes in. They're not going away yet. 63-53. Corey Dotris takes time. Doesn't let the 5 seconds go, then calls a quick timeout. And they're going to come down here, and there's Denny Stopper, played for the Williamsport Millionaires and Charlie Blackburn, late 60s, early 70s. 63-53 score in this ballgame. Let's take another timeout for Subway. We'll be back.
At Price Optical, we set our sights on your vision. Our focus is on providing complete quality eye care. Our selection includes designer frames by Giorgio Armani, Tommy Hilfiger, Ralph Lauren, and Calvin Klein. If specialty frames is what you're looking for, check out the durable, rimless frames by Silhouette and Kawasaki. We also have kids' frames. At Price Optical, our selection is great and our service is better. After all, quality is always the best deal. Price Optical, for the finest in eyewear.
Fairfield game of the week, Fairfield for fair deals. Dotrish inbound, McLean with a 10-point lead, 47 seconds left. And now Hughesville, you pretty much have to put these guys to the line if you get the ball back. You better hope for a steal, and there's reach in by Treese. They put McLean there, but you can't, yeah, that's tough. You put this team at the line, they'll just kill you. They do not miss at the free throw line with 10-point lead, 40 seconds, and stick around in our post-game show. Looks like we'll bring some more Lancers up. That has been the story this year. They've been the hot team, and you've seen them a lot on TV. In the big games, Goodell, McLean, we'll see who we bring up. McLean in a big second half here being shut out early. But give Nick Tagliaferri's team a lot of credit. McLean's got 17 points all in the second half of the game. He had 15 in the second half. We did have two free throws, I should say. Did not have a field goal until the third period. He's got 18.
I like what Nick Tagliaferri's done with this Hughesville club. They're disciplined. They play well. As he said, they haven't peaked yet, and I agree with him. I think this team can go further than what they are right now, but boy, they are playing well.
Good hustle, Lacher. Treese, and getting in the way. Saying other guys had a good second half is Nate Densher. Nate Densher's really done a great job, second half in particular. He's always the guy that they put on their toughest offensive player to shut him down. Danny Hefner for CI that got the two T's and is in the locker room now. And that doesn't happen very often to CI, but tonight it came in a flurry. Densher had 10 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, couple of steals. And Nate, a big second half and 2 3-point shots. He's got 11. 65-53, and Hughesville again played them tough. Played them tough the first time before falling 73-59, right before 4 days before Christmas Day. 66-53 score in this ball game with 13-point lead with 20 seconds. 18 seconds, Treese. The three won't go, and Goodell, the rebound, and there's nothing you can do now. And Hughesville's just going to let it play out. There's McLean with 8, with 7, with 5, 4. Loyal Sock goes to 17-1. Hughesville gave him a ball game. Young coach Nick Tagliaferri. Boy, he's got the program working, though, for the green and white. And they'll be in the play. They're going to make the playoffs before it's all over. And they're 66-53. They go to 10-7 in the year. But Nick's going to have them there. And I'm impressed with them. They played well against the area's best team.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. I think Nick Tagliaferri's done a good job. He's taken his team to another level. He's taking his team up to a playing level where he can compete with the Loyal Sox and he can compete with the schools in the conference. You're right, he's going to make the playoffs, and I think as well as making the playoffs, I think he's going to get a good seed, and I'll tell you, I think they're going to play well.
66-53, final score of this basketball game. Let's take a timeout for Subway. Subway has the new patented Subway toaster oven. All of a sudden, those cold subs become cosmos in seconds. Check it out at a Subway near you. Golden Strip, Newberry, Southside, and the Lake Cutting Mall. Stick around for the postgame show and our stars of the game, plus City Bus Big Play and more. 66-53. We'll be back.
Nobody beats a Fairfield Toyota deal.
We always have the lowest prices and best selection.
So you can be sure you'll get a great deal of Fairfield Fair Deals.
Save on every Toyota on our lot, from Camrys to Corollas to 4Runners.
We always have a great selection in stock and ready to go.
And we guarantee...